Good evening, everybody. We welcome you to the Winston Salem Fairgrounds Annex, where the Carolina Thunderbirds are set to take on the Danbury Hat Tricks in the second leg of a back-to-back here from the Fairgrounds Annex. Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for being with us. My name is Dylan Clark. The Thunderbirds and Hat Tricks, two teams kind of searching things out here in the FPHL, teams trending in different directions. Hat Tricks, losers of four of their last five, and Carolina, after a difficult patch of their own, have now put together two consecutive wins. And they look to get the sweep here this weekend against the Danbury Hat Tricks on home ice. Some roster moves have shaken things up here in Winston-Salem. Some players out, some injuries to get to. As always, that seems to be the story here in the early goings of this 2021 season. We'll get to those in a little bit. And we'll take a quick second after this break. We talked to head coach of the Thunderbirds, Garrett Rutledge. As always, we talked about some of the scoring things going on, players leading the way offensively, and how some help on the blue line has been a big help for the Thunderbirds over the last little bit. One more quick break, and we'll talk to Coach Rutledge after that.
Conveniently located at the corner of Rinalda Road and Northwest Boulevard, Salem Smiles and Dr. Sarah C. Schoaf is the preferred orthodontist of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Dr. Schoaf is a Winston-Salem native and a trusted name in orthodontics since 1992. So whether you're on the ice or in the stands, trust your teeth to Dr. Smashmouth and her team at Salem Smiles.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
After the success of the Vanilla Coffee Porter, the Carolina Thunderbirds and Fiddlin' Fish Brewing Company are back with another instant classic, the Thunderbirds Blonde Ale. Smooth and easy drinking, it's the perfect beer for cheering on the birds. Don't delay. These cans are limited edition. Get yours at the game, in the grocery store, or at Fiddlin' Fish on Trade Street.
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist.
A lot has changed since 1933, but one thing that hasn't is Modern Automotive's commitment to you. North Carolina car buyers have trusted Modern for 85 years for affordable prices, big selection, and an everlasting commitment to local schools, youth programs, and charitable organizations. It has been our pleasure to earn your business and help make a difference in our community.
Experience the Modern difference. Family owned since 1933.
Welcome back to Winston-Salem. First year head coach Garrett Rutledge picked up in his 10th career game his first win against the Danbury Hat Tricks, a team against whom his team, the Carolina Thunderbirds, have struggled over the last little bit. After getting that first win against the Hat Tricks, Coach Rutledge talked about the offensive success and things to build on going forward. Here's Coach Rutledge now.
Welcome back to the Winston-Salem Fairgrounds Annex. Dylan Clark alongside head coach of the Thunderbirds, Garrett Rutledge. Coach, 6-3 win last night, two wins in a row for you and your team. What impressed you the most about your team's effort last night?
I just thought from the drop of the puck, we came out on a mission, playing at home. Had a little swagger last night to our step. We had finally a pretty full lineup and some new players in the lineup that give us just that shot in the arm we needed, and obviously it worked out.
Chris Hunt with a pair of goals last night. He's got 6 points in his last two games. What does he bring to the table offensively that it's allowed him to have such success?
Hunt's been great. Like I said, all he does is put the puck in the net for us. So he's made a couple trips up to the SB, getting some his feet wet up there and stuff. So coming back with us, he puts the work in. Like I said, he He allows himself to learn during practice and stuff. And I think he's absorbed the structure. And like I said, I'm a big coach and proponent, and I reward guys when they're playing well. And I think he's starting to learn that that's the way it works, and he's fitting in well.
Second leg of a back-to-back tonight against the Hat Tricks. What do you expect adjustment-wise from them into tonight's game?
I've probably figured that they're going to trap a little bit more. I thought we gained a lot of speed through the neutral zone and the O-zone. We had a lot of attack time, and looking at the analytics of the game and stuff, our puck possession, we had our puck on the stick a lot of the time. So you'll probably see Danbury probably drop back a lot, trying to slow us down, kind of flooding the neutral zone, I would imagine. So we'll make our adjustments to that, and we should be ready to go again tonight.
Charlie Pelnick seems to bring a lot of stability onto the back end. How does he kind of adjust and tool with the way you guys can play?
I just think, like, he just brings, again, stability to our back end. He's a big physical presence. Just looking at him right away, our guys play a little bit bigger when he's on the ice. He makes the simple plays. He's an honest player. If you're an opposing team every night, you're going to have to play against him as a forward. He's a guy that you don't want to go in the front of the net with. You don't want to go in the corner. And when you know he's on the ice, you kind of, like, in the back of your mind, you kind of dread that. And after playing 60 minutes against him all night, if you're the top line guy, you're looking over your shoulder a little bit when he's out there. So he keeps everybody honest. Like I said, he's a pleasure to have, and he's a presence and a very good leader on the bench. And he's a very good calming effect too. He's a very calm, cool guy. But like I said, I'd love to have him.
Last question, another defenseman. Cody Oakes got his first goal in a Thunderbirds uniform after hitting the post on an empty netter two nights ago. What did it mean to you and to the team to see him get his first as a Thunderbird?
A kid like Cody, he's one of the most liked kids on our team. He's always got a big smile on his face. He's a character. It's great to see a homegrown kid having success. And like I said, even without the goal, like you can hear the crowd buzzing when he picks the puck up behind the net and starts coming up the ice. Like, it's fun to watch a kid play and have success in our organization, especially, like I said, he's got lots of family and friends here, and it's fun to watch him play and have success, and it must be very special for him here.
Coach, thanks as always for the time. Good luck tonight. We'll take one more break, and Thunderbirds pregame continues on the other side of it.
A lot has changed since 1933, but one thing that hasn't is Modern Automotive's commitment to you. North Carolina car buyers have trusted Modern for 85 years for affordable prices, big selection, and an everlasting commitment to local schools, youth programs, and charitable organizations. It has been our pleasure to earn your business and help make a difference in our community.
Experience the Modern difference. Family owned since 1933.
Conveniently located at the corner of Rinalda Road and Northwest Boulevard, Salem Smiles and Dr. Sarah C. Schoaf is the preferred orthodontist of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Dr. Schoaf is a Winston Salem native and a trusted name in orthodontics since 1992. So whether you're on the ice or in the stands, trust your teeth to Dr. Smashmouth and her team at Salem Smiles.
Sometimes we all need a bit of help. Come on. That's where North Carolina Golf Academy comes in.
Let me give you a little tip.
With four instructors ready to get your game to the next level, we're open to the public. Practice on our fully lit driving range and gear up at our pro shop. We're a proudly licensed Callaway dealer. Give us a call at 336-884-4653 and visit us in High Point.
There you go. That's a bomb.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So, we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
Welcome back to Winston-Salem. We are a few minutes away from puck drop here between Carolina and the Danbury Hat Tricks, coming off of a 6-3 loss to the hands of the Thunderbirds last night. In that game, though, going into it, the narrative was Danbury, a high-scoring, high-threat offense there coming into last night's game. averaging 4.5 goals for per game. The hat tricks fell a little short of that, 3 goals in last night's contest. But in the first period, it was the Danbury team that the Thunderbirds probably expected to see. Danbury outshot Carolina 17-15 in the opening frame. The score after 20 was 2-1 Carolina, but the hat tricks did not look to be beaten yet. They had just recently tied things up at the end of the first, and 30 seconds into the second period, tied the game up at 2 and really didn't go away until later on in the third period. Cody Oaks' empty net goal after Chris Hunt and John Batita tallies. That would put the hat tricks away. But up until that, the hat tricks really held on and gave Carolina a run for their money. Corey Anderson was the offensive catalyst all night for Danbury. Lots of shots on goal. One of the players that we talked about it last night, lots of players cut down the wing and try to get that high shot on goal. Up past the ear, over the shoulder, trying to pick that near glove side of the Carolina goaltenders. But a lot of times, and most of the time, when a player is in full stride, high speed, trying to make that shot down the wing, they're not going to hit the net. They send it up over the bar, they send it wide to the goalpost, or they put it kind of right into the goaltender's chest for an easy save and a faceoff. But Anderson had a number of attempts that came pretty darn close to hitting the back of the net. One of them hit the crossbar. Nick Modica forced to make a solid glove save, kind of pulling that glove hand up over top of his head on a number of occasions. But Anderson, not the only offensive threat for the hat tricks again. Johnny Ruiz and Dmitry Kuznetsov were all over the ice for Danbury as well, manufacturing a number of opportunities. 22 goals for the hat tricks between those three players. We expect to see a ton of them again tonight. Gordy Bunnell, 2 goals and an assist for 3 points. His 2 goals got things tied up there early in the second period for Danbury. Bunnell, a speedy player, left-handed shot, kind of gave the Thunderbirds fits early on in that game. But again, Bunnell expected to be another player to keep an eye on here for the Thunderbirds in this one, a player they had a hard time containing. And on the back end, Steve Brown and Aaron Atwell shutting things down and bringing the physicality for Danbury that way. Brown, again, North Carolina native, 248 FPHL games, 6'4", a tough customer. Not afraid to drop the gloves. Aaron Atwell and Tommy Cardinal squared off at center. That physicality, again, hadn't seen as many fights as maybe we had expected going into this game, but that one was kind of the fight of the season so far. Tommy Cardinal and Atwell, again, took a long time to get going, but once those two did finally start trading knuckles, it was a good one to watch. And the goaltending, a bit of a question mark for the hat tricks. Frankie McClendon, 5 goals on 43 shots last night. Former Thunderbird, not sure if he'll get the second consecutive start tonight. It looks like maybe we'll see William McEwen between the pipes tonight for Danbury. He's got 1 FPHL win. This is his first season for the hat tricks. 20 saves on 24 shots in his one appearance. It was a 6-5 win against the Port Huron Prowlers a few weeks ago. Take another quick break, and when we come back, we'll do the same, breaking down Carolina and some new and old faces coming back into the lineup. All that after this.
Conveniently located at the corner of Rinalda Road and Northwest Boulevard, Salem Smiles and Dr. Sarah C. Schoaf is the preferred orthodontist of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Dr. Schoaf is a Winston Salem native and a trusted name in orthodontics since 1992. So whether you're on the ice or in the stands, trust your teeth to Dr. Smashmouth and her team at Salem Smiles.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So, we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
After the success of the Vanilla Coffee Porter, the Carolina Thunderbirds and Fiddlin' Fish Brewing Company are back with another instant classic, the Thunderbirds Blonde Ale. Smooth and easy drinking, it's the perfect beer for cheering on the birds. Don't delay, these cans are limited edition. Get yours at the game, in the grocery store, or at Fiddlin' Fish on Trade Street.
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist.
Welcome back to Winston-Salem. Puck drop just a few minutes away here between Carolina and the Danbury Hattricks. Thunderbirds again coming off a 6-3 win last night, and their offense has been rejuvenated over the last little bit. 6-3 last night, 4-2 against the Columbus River Dragons on Wednesday night. The Thunderbirds, the bounces seem to finally be going their way. It really seemed as though puck luck was against them over the last few weeks. Again, their first win in regulation in the month of November, coming Wednesday night against the Hattricks. First win in regulation in this building in November, coming last night against the Hattricks. Wednesday night against Columbus, I meant to say earlier. But again, Thunderbirds offense rejuvenated, and leading that charge, especially last night and over the last little bit, has been Chris Hunt, Albany native. 6 points in his last two games, had two goals last night. Hunt just been all over the place. And again, as the Thunderbirds have added more offensive weapons, it's kind of taking the pressure off of other players and opened things up, allowed them to use some more of their creativity and play more to their style, which is really what head coach Rutledge has kind of set things up to really put an emphasis on the creativity and the natural talents and abilities and tendencies of his players, and utilizing those strengths and putting the system around them that way. So Chris Hunt and company kind of leading the charge that way. Hunt leads the Thunderbirds in points with 12. And he'll look to be, again, another player leading the way for them tonight. He's been playing on the line with John Batita, second on the team in scoring with 11 points. Those two, not the only scoring threats out there. Again, we talked about it at length last night. Scotty Donahue, Gus Ford, and Devin Warfield, a line to really keep an eye on. Again, that line seemed to have the puck in much of the opportunities, probably the most of any line on the ice, save maybe for Danbury's top line, Johnny Ruiz, on that one. But that was really the line for Carolina. They were only rewarded once, a power play goal for Warfield in his Thunderbirds debut. But again, those three expected to stay together and expected to carry the mail offensively. You watch Gus Ford, 10 in red for the Thunderbirds. The puck just kind of sticks to him in the offensive end, and really keeping things at an offensive clip, setting up opportunities that wouldn't otherwise be there. Gus Ford, again, compared to Mitch Marner, at least at this stage of the game, by head coach Rutledge. And the special teams, again, driving the bus for the Thunderbirds. Top-ranked power play in the FPHL after a few weeks where it was kind of down in the basement, down at 14% at one point. They're first in the FPHL right now, and their penalty kill sits at second. Only team with a better penalty kill than the Carolina Thunderbirds is the Columbus River Dragons, who, as we know, didn't surrender a power play goal against in their first 20-odd opportunities. So good company there for the Thunderbirds at the top of the league in the special teams categories. And on the back end, Charlie Pelnick, Thunderbirds added him to the lineup not too long ago. 6'5", North Carolina-grown player, has really added some stability, added some physical force. And when the opposition sees 11 on the ice, really makes them think about, well, which corner do I really want to go into? It's made that much of a difference. And you heard Garrett Rutledge talk about that earlier on in his pregame interview. We'll take another break, and on the other side of it, we'll talk about some injuries and transactions. We talked about some surprise faces in the lineup tonight. You want to stick around for this one.
A lot has changed since 1933, but one thing that hasn't is Modern Automotive's commitment to you. North Carolina car buyers have trusted Modern for 85 years for affordable prices, big selection, and an everlasting commitment to local schools, youth programs, and charitable organizations. It has been our pleasure to earn your business and help make a difference in our community.
Experience the Modern difference. Family owned since 1933.
Conveniently located at the corner of Rinalda Road and Northwest Boulevard, Salem Smiles and Dr. Sarah C. Schoaf is the preferred orthodontist of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Dr. Schoaf is a Winston-Salem native and a trusted name in orthodontics since 1992. So whether you're on the ice or in the stands, trust your teeth to Dr. Smashmouth and her team at Salem Smiles.
Sometimes, we all need a bit of help. Come on. That's where North Carolina Golf Academy comes in.
Let me give you a little tip.
With four instructors ready to get your game to the next level, we're open to the public. Practice on our fully lit driving range and gear up at our pro shop. We're a proudly licensed Callaway dealer. Give us a call at 336-884-4653
and visit us in High Point.
There you go. That's a bomb.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
Welcome back to Carolina. The Thunderbirds about to get on our way here against the Danbury Hattricks, but before puck drop, some injuries and transactions, and some transactions brought about by injuries. Nick Modica injured early in the second period of last night's contest, went down to make a save, and did not return after falling down to the ice and having to be carried off. Modica out with a lower body injury for the foreseeable future. So as a result, Thunderbirds general manager Kelly Curl signed as an emergency backup goaltender for tonight's contest and for at least the immediate future here going forward for the Thunderbird. Curl played about 68 games for the Thunderbirds and a few other teams dressing as an E-Bug over the last three seasons, dating all the way back to the Thunderbirds' inaugural season, 2017-2018. So expect to see Kelly Curl on the bench, and that'll mean Chris Paulin between the pipes tonight for the Thunderbirds. He made all 17 saves last night, coming in relief of Nick Modica and guiding the Thunderbirds to that 6-3 win. Paulin credited with the win because the game-winning goal was scored while he was between the pipes, so Paulin's third win of the season last night, coming in relief. Chris Corgan has been traded to the Delaware Thunder earlier this afternoon in exchange for future considerations. Brian Moore returns from his SPHL loan. Scored a handful of points with the Fayetteville Marksmen in just two games. Three goals in that brief stint. Everett Thompson is still up with the Marksmen on a loan to the SPHL. He won't be available for tonight's contest. And Cameron Dimmitt still out for the Thunderbirds with a lower body injury. Vinny DeAndre, as a result of some players coming back into the lineup, DeAndre was released. He'll be on the bench tonight, as he was last night, as an assistant coach for Garrett Rutledge and the Carolina Thunderbirds. Quick look at the out-of-town scoreboard. Binghamton at Delaware tonight. The Delaware Thunder continuing to struggle against the Black Bears. They fell last night as well. Delaware still searching for their first win of the season. And the Columbus River Dragons in New York tonight to take on the Watertown Wolves. Again, those two teams leading their respective divisions. Watertown, a force to be reckoned with out of the East Division. They took down the River Dragons last night. Those two going toe-to-toe tonight. That'll come around at 7 o'clock, we believe. And so we'll keep an eye on those games coming for you. And one more quick break when we come back. Keys to the game. And on the other side of that, puck drop here between Carolina and Danbury.
Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist helps you do more of the things you love. More laughs, more adventures, more hugs. We combine the brightest minds in medicine to bring you world-class care with a commitment to strengthen the health and wellness of our community. Because when it comes to the health of you and your family, no one should settle for anything short of life-changing.
After the success of the Vanilla Coffee Porter, the Carolina Thunderbirds and Fiddlin' Fish Brewing Company are back with another instant classic. The Thunderbirds Blonde. Get yours at the game, in the grocery store, or at Fiddlin' Fish on Trade Street.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
A lot has changed since 1933, but one thing that hasn't is Modern Automotive's commitment to you. North Carolina car buyers have trusted Modern for 85 years for affordable prices, big selection, and an everlasting commitment to local schools, youth programs, and charitable organizations. It has been our pleasure to earn your business and help make a difference in our community.
Experience the Modern difference. family owned since 1933.
Family owned.
Back inside the Winston-Salem Fairgrounds Annex, Dylan Clark with you as we inch closer to puck drop here. Second leg of a back-to-back between the Danbury Hattricks and Carolina Thunderbirds. Again, teams on the opposite paths right now. Danbury sliding and the Thunderbirds trying to surge and build some momentum here as they enter the month of December. Time now for our keys to tonight's game. Carolina coming off a 6-3 win last night. Lots of things went well for them. First and foremost, the special teams game. Thunderbirds won that handily. 2-for-5 on the power play last night, making the most of their opportunities. Again, over the past few weeks, it seems as though the Thunderbirds had been getting those opportunities. Tons of power play chances, just could not make things work. They ran into a stiff opposition in the River Dragons penalty kill over the last five games before last night's matchup, but Thunderbirds starting to break through on the power play with more and more regularity. 2-for-5 last night, and they held the Danbury power play to an absolute standstill. 0-for-7 on the man advantage last night for the Hattricks. Still the second power play in the league at 20%, but if the Thunderbirds can keep that at a halt and keep power play goals against to a minimum, again, another sure way to try and open up the window for victory there. And second key to tonight's game, using the entire rink. Thunderbirds had been limited in their creativity coming into the offensive zone. The passing was kind of linear. Not a ton of options were open for them, but in last night's contest, they really tried to open things up. Use every inch of available space in the offensive zone, especially on the power play goal. Carolina's first power play goal, probably the best indicator of those opportunities. Carolina moving the puck a ton before that power play goal was set up. So moving things around there and keeping them in motion, keeping the Hattricks on their toes and really not allowing them to gain a footing in the defensive zone gave Carolina that edge they needed. Again, using all of the ice and all of the space that is available to you, it's there. Take advantage of it. Third key to tonight's game is keep playing the speed game. The Thunderbirds have added more and more players that can really fly out there. Gus Ford, one of them. Jacob Schnapp, another. Blake Peavy, another one that's been really all over the ice for the Thunderbirds, providing some depth scoring for them. Playing important minutes on the power play and the penalty kill. But the guys that can really wheel around, and again, this kind of coincides with using the entire rink, using all the space that is available to you. But those players that can really move the puck with speed, and there were times when the Hattricks were caught completely off guard. Chris Hunt, not typically known for being a speed guy, really found an extra gear last night for the Thunderbirds' fifth goal of the game, wrapping things around the goaltender there, using the speed down the wing. If the Thunderbirds can do that tonight, they'll be well on their way in trying to get the second win against the Hattricks in as many games. We'll take one more break to have the national anthem here, and then puck drop on the other side of this break here from the Fairgrounds Annex.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So, we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
Maple Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad. Come enjoy a meal at the Pine Brook Bar and Grill. Relax by our pool and cabana. Gear up at the Pro Shop and sharpen your skills on our 9,000 square foot putting green. And play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. Find out more at MapleChaseCC.com.
A lot has changed since 1933, but one thing that hasn't is Modern Automotive's commitment to you. North Carolina car buyers have trusted Modern for 85 years for affordable prices, big selection, and an everlasting commitment to local schools, youth programs, and charitable organizations. It has been our pleasure to earn your business and help make a difference in our community.
Experience the Modern difference. Family owned since 1933.
The Carolina Thunderbirds have a set of two custom wine labels that can be yours to take home today. The Thunderbirds Red and Carolina White are special edition, first-run custom wine labels for Carolina Thunderbirds fans. Bottles are $40 individually and $75 when bought as a set. Call the Thunderbirds office to get yours today. 336-774-4625.
Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist helps you do more of the things you love. More laughs, more adventures, more hugs. We combine the brightest minds in medicine to bring you world-class care with a commitment to strengthen the health and wellness of our community. Because when it comes to the health of you and your family, no one should settle for anything short of life-changing.
After the success of the Vanilla Coffee Porter, the Carolina Thunderbirds and
from Winston-Salem, North Carolina, the Federal Prospects Hockey League is proud to present the Carolina Thunderbirds and the Danbury Hat Tricks going toe-to-toe for the second consecutive night. Thunderbirds, winners of their last two games. Hat Tricks sliding here, losing four of their last five. Our Pine Hall Bricks starting goaltenders for tonight. Chris Paulin came in and made all 17 shots, saved all 17 shots sent his way in relief last night after Nick Modica went down with a lower body injury. He gets the start tonight, his first set of back-to-back appearances this season. And down to our left, William McEwen for the Danbury Hat Tricks, coming in and making just his second FPHL start. He won his first 6-5 over the Port Huron Prowlers just a few weekends ago. The Blake Peavy line starts out against Dmitry Kuznetsov and Corey Anderson for the Danbury Hat Tricks, down and underway. Thunderbirds move right to left to start this one. So thankful you could be with us, everybody. From Winston-Salem, Carolina, against Danbury. Out of the neutral zone, a bouncing puck settled down by Steve Brown and guided all the way onto the far side. Hat Tricks chip this one and roll it back into Carolina territory. On the tape now of Cody Oakes, scored his first Thunderbirds goal last night, an empty netter as this one goes all the way back down 200 feet. For an icing, bringing the faceoff to the glove hand side of Chris Paulin. 24 seconds gone in this first period, brought to you by First Bank. Carolina, with their win last night, has slipped up into second place in the FPHL's West Division. Yuri Peshtuka off the defensive zone faceoff, tries to throw this one up to Jacob Schnapp. Two games played in a Thunderbird uniform, three goals, and he's on the puck right now in the left wing corner. Schnapp, bumped there by Anderson, lets one go to Talipov up top. Blocked away and in behind the goal. Peavy getting tangled up there with Steve Brown. Brown bats that one out of the air. On his backhand, flips it up now for Tilburg. And this one moved back in. Thunderbirds have it. Hunt working back down low against Brown. Brian Moore on the ice now. His first Thunderbirds game since the Watertown series a few weekends ago. This one chipped all the way back out, and George Holt back to claim it. 6 points in three Thunderbirds games for Brian Moore. About a minute and a quarter gone in the opening frame of this one. And as a scrum on the far side corner, Gordy Bunnell goes down as he tangles with George Holt. Gus Ford trying to take the heat out of a hot kitchen here for Carolina. Talipov finds a man up the wing there. A quick shot rising there. Scotty Donahue, as that puck goes up and out of play again after the return of Brian Moore. He'll be wearing his number 16 against Scotty Donahue, who wore that number last night. He'll wear number 7 for tonight. Chris Corgan traded to the Delaware Thunder earlier this afternoon. Gus Ford on with Donahue and Devin Warfield. The line to keep an eye on here in the early goings of this one. Far side, Bunnell chipping this one back out. Nicoletti back playing defense after a brief stint up on the wing as Chris Paulin comes out and tries to drop that one off for Brian Moore. 2 minutes gone, First Bank first period. Moore coughs the puck up. Taken down by the Hat Tricks. Quick shot there up high, punched aside there by Paulin. Takes some contact after the fact, back on his skates. Here comes Gus Ford with more down the right side. Here comes Ford, lowers the shoulder. He gets spun out right in front. Nicoletti, a backhand chance. Goes off some sticks and up into the netting, out of play. Offensive zone draw coming up here for the Thunderbirds, and there you see it, the playmaking abilities of Gus Ford. A slippery player trying to work his way around Steve Brown. He got the angle on him, though. Brown spinning out Gus Ford cleanly. The puck out of play. Another offensive zone draw come up for the Thunderbirds. Batita with Warfield and Daniel Martin. Batita second on the team in scoring, 11 points this year. Leads the team with 35 shots on goal here in this young 2021 campaign. Move back ahead. White Duck chips this one in. Kodiak White Duck, as we'll have a whistle and a stoppage here. Native of Kitigan Zibi, First Nations Reserve up in Quebec, the largest First Nations Reserve in the province. And off the icing, this puck comes all the way back down. Another offensive zone draw for Batita from the left wing circle. Wins it back. Daniel Martin, a long shot off the glove of McEwen, comes back off a defender. McEwen able to make that save. A bit of an awkward bounce in front. Aaron Atwell. That one went off the shaft of his stick and back in on McEwen, forced him to make a second good stop. Aaron Atwell, 2019 Defenseman of the Year for the Danbury Hat Tricks. 2015 FPHL champion with the Watertown Wolves. Team leader in assists with 7 of them right now. As Corey Anderson gets tangled up there with Devin Warfield, those two slide down. Puck moved back in and whistle. And a tripping call coming up here. Devin Warfield will go sit for 2. 17:07, and the Hat Tricks will go to the game's first power play. Hat Tricks 0-7 last night. This is their first man advantage of the hockey game. 8-39 on the season. Good for 20.5%. Again, second in the FPHL. Carolina, 84% on the penalty kill as this one cleared the zone. Second in the FPHL behind only the Columbus River Dragons. As the Hat Tricks power play starts things out from their own end. Anderson skates away from Tommy Cardinal. Over the line, Anderson has his pocket picked. He gets taken down by Blake Peavy, and Cody Oakes clears the zone. Cardinal now down the right side. Shorthanded chance for the Thunderbirds. Lays a shoulder into Aaron Atwell, and the puck comes all the way back around Tal Finberg there. Dropping for Atwell. Behind the Hat Tricks goal, Atwell slowly lumbers out, takes a look and throws a flipping puck all the way up the wall. Steady collision there, and Johnny Ruiz gets spun out. So the Hat Tricks back again. Minute 11 to go on the power play. Warfield in the box, 2 for tripping. Hat Tricks unable to get any solid opportunities on this power play as John Batita comes together with Gordy Bunnell down the right side. Danbury able to move this one back in. It's Ruiz. Bunnell now back up top. Daniluk tries to send one in front. Paulin made the save there. As Talipov comes together in the corner with Ruiz. Loose puck gathered in by Batita and sent the length of the ice. 39 seconds left on the Warfield penalty. 15:40 to go in the first period, brought to you by First Bank. Bunnell over the line, tries to step around George Holt. He goes down. And Cody Oakes gathers back the other way, shorthanded with Blake Peavy. Just chipped that one in. Bit of a miscommunication on the pass there. Those two wanted the line change. Instead, here comes Ruiz back down the right side for the Hat Tricks. Ruiz circles in behind. Goal of Chris Paulin. He gets tangled up with Tommy Cardinal. And Cardinal clears it again for the Thunderbirds. 7 seconds to go on the Warfield penalty. Thunderbirds 3-2-1 have killed it off. Back at full strength. Line change coming. Brian Moore steps on with Donahue and Blake Peavy. Stretch pass there intended up the left wing for Michael Lopez. It doesn't connect, but no icing, so David Nicoletti has to come back for the Thunderbirds. He and Lopez come together. Puck chip back in deep. Flipped around the glass over the head of the official. Nicoletti has to keep that one away from Michael Lopez. Nicoletti on it now. Moving it up the far wall for Scotty Donahue, and that one Backhanded off of Bonnie, out of play. 14:30 to go. First period from Winston-Salem. We're scoreless. We'll take a quick break here.
Conveniently located at the corner of Rinalda Road and Northwest Boulevard, Salem Smiles and Dr. Sarah C. Schoaf is the preferred orthodontist of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Dr. Schoaf is a Winston-Salem native and a trusted name in orthodontics since 1992. So whether you're on the ice or in the stands, trust your teeth to Dr. Smashmouth and her team at Salem Smiles.
Welcome back to Winston-Salem. Scoreless here in the early goings of this first period. Just announced over the PA system, Kelly Curl again, the emergency backup goaltender tonight for the Thunderbirds. McLeansville, North Carolina native in his second year as Carolina's general manager. Brought into action as the E-Bug after Nick Modica's injury last night early in the second period. Part of that 2019 Commissioner's Cup Championship team here in Winston-Salem as Paulin drops it off for Nicoletti behind the goal. That turns into a hairy situation, and coming back to help out Gus Ford, chipping it on now for Brian Moore. Moore sidesteps the forechecking Finberg. Off the skate and the stick of Scotty Donahue. Collected at center and backhanded in by Atwell. Thunderbird center the length of the ice now for an icing. Nicoletti will have to stay on there. 13:54 to go. First period here. 2-1 the shots. Thunderbirds leading in that category. Again, the shots through 20 minutes in last night's first period. 17-15 the hat tricks leaders in that category. Danbury outshot their opponents, the Binghamton Black Bears, 62-28 just a handful of games ago, as this one off the draw move back to the point. Vinny Susi couldn't hold that one in. Taken by Gus Ford. Now to the near side, Moore. With Ford headed towards the goal. Here comes Moore. Delays in the slot. Hit the crossbar. What a chance for Brian Moore. Takes a hit now on the far side. Hat-tricks come back the other way. Best look of the night so far for Carolina. Long shot by Kuznetsov. Hits a leg. Thunderbirds in transition. Here comes Ford down the left side. Stops up. Drops for Scotty Donahue. Donahue in the slot there. Right on. A glove save and the rebound is loose. Finally covered up on there by McEwen. Gus Ford is escorted away from the blue paint by Vinny Susi. Nothing more comes of that one. 13:22 to go. Good opportunity there by Brian Moore. Had the defender sprawled out. Dragged the puck with him. As we've got some repairs to the goal right now, making sure the anchors that hold it in place are in tip-top shape. Brian Moore, 6 points in just 3 appearances here for the Thunderbirds. This is his 4th game in a Carolina uniform. Long shot there by Jacob Schnapp. That may have caught the goalpost or perhaps the goaltender as well. Near side. Brett Jackson now works it all the way back out. Gordy Bunnell. Bunnell against Pestuka. Wanted the centering feed to Ruiz. He gets tangled up there with Talipov in the slot. Jacob Schnapp gets bumped there by Jackson. Turning shot by Ruiz. Saved by Paulin. And he'll cover for a faceoff. 12:58 to go. First period here. Carolina against the Danbury Hat-Tricks. NHL jersey night here at the Annex tonight. Took a couple of moments because some of the fans that you get used to seeing, some of the season ticket holders that typically wearing Thunderbirds jerseys, you got to do a double take because, well, there's a Patrick Waugh, there's a couple of Sidney Crosbys, there's a Rod Brendamore, and you got to think, oh, hang on a second, it's NHL jersey night. George Holt down the left side. Taken into the boards firmly there by Brown. Holt back on his feet. Puck moved around far side. Bunnell. Flip pass here and the bouncing puck as Cody Oakes gets taken down. Comes on now to Devin Warfield. Warfield down the left side. Little shimmy shake. Makes some room for himself. Tries to curl it back up the wall for Cody Oakes. Instead, the hat tricks bury it back down below the goal line. Daniluk on this one. Tries to chip it on his backhand for Brett Jackson. Held in, though, by Cody Oakes for a moment. Move back down. Martin takes a hit on his back pocket. Dan will look down out of the corner away from John Batita. Martin circling as well. Up it comes, up the wall. Warfield sends one on goal there. McEwen turns it aside with the goal stick. Martin battling for possession. Can't come away with it. Atwell finds Jackson. And the outlet pass has to be skated into now by Dimitri Daniluk. Long shot, skied in on Chris Paulin, hits him right in the Thunderbirds' crest, and he'll hold for a faceoff. 11:55 to go in a scoreless first period. 5-3 Thunderbirds leading on the shot board right now. Couple of close calls, and this one taking a few moments to kind of open up. About halfway through the period, as a flutter shot in on goal. Bit of a dangerous look there. Charlie Pelnick with confidence handling that one in around Chris Paulin's goal. As the arm of the official is up, as Pelnick collects himself, we will have the first Thunderbirds power play of the game. Kodiak White Duck will go take a seat two for tripping. Back-to-back tripping calls to open tonight's game. White Duck in the box. Gus Ford out with Donahue and Brian Moore. He's got the puck now. Guides it back for Pelnick. Moore has it. Yuri Pestuka, the fifth member of this power play unit for Carolina. Pelnick near side. Pestuka in their own end. Away from the forechecking Corey Anderson. And now Gus Ford takes over. Ford. The red line hits Pestuka. Back in deep, left wing corner. Ford on the backhand, rolls it up the wall. Brian Moore is there. Moore gathers, tries to skate across the blue line, shrugs off Kuznetsov. Moore back down low, finds Ford, right wing corner, back up top. Pelnick fakes the shot from the blue line, sends a saucer pass back down low. Ford with a little give and go there from Moore. But instead off the turnover, Dmitry Kuznetsov has it, skated out to center, but meanders back in to clear it all the way back down. Solid heads-up play there by Kuznetsov. Kill a little more time off this power play. Already a minute gone on it. Stretch pass by Talipov finds Moore. Nice feed on the near side here. Cross-ice pass taken by Cody Oakes. In behind the goal now. Works it around to Blake Peavy. Peavy wanted to go back down low for Oakes. Instead, he goes back up top. Moore. Couple of head fakes and some smooth skating. A nice backhand pass. Here comes Peavy, the long shot, and McEwen makes the save. What a difference having Brian Moore in the lineup makes. Again, just a puck possession monster in the offensive zone for the Thunderbirds. Never quite sure what he's going to do next. You see him just freeze defenders with that skating ability. Bit of confusion off the faceoff as the hat tricks work this one back out. Jake Schnapp on it up top. Talipov moves it underneath now for Chris Hunt. Hunt, two goals in last night's contest, waiting as he comes out, tries to throw that one in front. Talipov has it on the near side goalpost. Now back underneath he comes. Up top, Cody Oakes, center point. Now across for Talipov, has to settle down off his skate. In the slot, a rising shot goes high. Off the boards, Oakes able to hold it in right in front of the Danbury bench. Here comes Oakes, 41 seconds, long shot, save made, rebound loose in front. Peavy didn't know where it was. McEwen had vacated the blue paint as this one cleared the length of the ice. And we'll have a stoppage with 10:18 to go. There are five hat tricks on the ice. Will they call too many men? Well, while this gets sorted out, we'll take a brief media timeout here. Just about 10 minutes to go in the first period. Still scoreless from Winston-Salem.
Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist helps you do more of the things you love. More laughs. More adventures. More hugs. We combine the brightest minds in medicine to bring you world-class care with a commitment to strengthen the health and wellness of our community. Because when it comes to the health of you and your family, no one should settle for anything short of life-changing.
Welcome back to Winston-Salem. White Duck has been released from the hat tricks penalty box. There were still a few seconds left on his penalty, as it looks like maybe a clock malfunction here from the Fairgrounds Annex. Perhaps a little premature. They put about 7 seconds on. There were about 7 seconds left, and the clock began to run down. They pulled White Duck from the penalty box, and the linesman having a conversation right now with head coach Garrett Rutledge over on the far side boards. We'll take a few moments and let this one be sorted out. 6-3 Carolina leading on the shot board. Chris Paulin hasn't been tested often, but strong so far. William McEwen as well. Down to our left for the hat tricks. Just his second FPHL game. As a neutral zone faceoff here for Carolina. As we look to be all sorted out. About 9:40 to go in the first period, so maybe a clock malfunction. Try to get some answers for you in the first intermission, but right now the puck in the Danbury zone. Daniel Martin tries to spin out Atwell, picked off at the line. Here comes Cardinal in the slot, a shot high and wide. That puck rolls back in off the boards. McEwen able to cover that one. Tommy Cardinal still waiting for his first points in his second tour of duty with Carolina. Finding his physical game more and more as time goes along. You see him, the confidence is building. He's shooting the puck more, so only a matter of time before Cardinal able to break through as this one, a little chip in charge. Bit premature of the red line, so it comes all the way back down for an icing. Thunderbirds, after this, will have a bit of an interesting situation. They have played, well, tied for the most games in the FPHL. Columbus and Port Huron have played just 8. But the Thunderbirds, it will now be their turn to be without a partner next weekend as a nice play by Corey Anderson sidesteps a defenseman. Long shot on Chris Paul and easily sticked aside. So Carolina off next weekend. They'll draw Port Huron the weekend after that, too, up at McMoran Arena on a Thursday and Friday. One back here in Winston-Salem on Saturday as Kuznetsov breaks over the line here for the hat tricks. Quickly taken away there by Scotty Donahue. Hat tricks all over that one. Dumped in. Near side corner, Pestuka. Gives over to Holt. Outlet pass. Brian Moore watches that one go by. A little too far for him. 8:33 to go. First bank, first period. Brian Moore returning from a brief stint with the Fayetteville Marksmen just a few nights ago. 3 goals for them. Everett Thompson up with the Marksmen right now. Fayetteville off at this current time as a stretch pass. Scotty Donahue down the right side cuts in and sends that one wide. Past the blocker hand of McEwen. Back out. Here come the hat tricks. Into the offensive end. They get tangled up with each other. Picked off by George Holt. Off the skates and ahead. Here comes a chance for Gus Ford. Drops it off. Moore. Quick shot. Sent that one wide on the blocker side. Brilliant opportunity. Ford and Moore. Those two linking up on a number of opportunities. Several occasions here in the first period. 8 minutes to go. Moore takes a man into the boards. Looks to be Danilook. And on this one, Ford from the goal line. Sends it up top. Nicoletti. Knows Moore's there. Sends a blind backhand pass. It escapes him by a little bit. Moore without a stick. Ford in front. Quick shot there low. Tommy Cardinal had a chance. Cardinal chips it underneath for Ford. Ford doubled up on by a pair of hat tricks. Still works the puck free though. Tries to get it loose to Brian Moore. Can't do it. Near side. Charlie Pelnick sends it back in from the blue line. Two Thunderbirds against two hat tricks. Near side corner. Brought out now by Cardinal. Long shot there off the goalpost. Quick release by Tommy Cardinal. Surprise McEwen. Pelnick chips it back in. Brian Moore now out of the right wing corner. Taken to the boards by Vinny Susi. Cardinal on it now. Fakes the shot. Pelnick back over Nicoletti. Center point. Long shot. Tips on its way. Rebound is loose in the crease. No one knew where it was. And now Danilook clears it off the boards. Nice job by Nicoletti to keep that puck alive. Thunderbirds in the zone for nearly a minute straight here as finally the hat tricks clear it back down off the dasher. Nicoletti hustles back. He won't need to. They'll be icing with 6:51 to go in a scoreless first period, but Thunderbirds inching closer and closer here. By this point in last night's contest, Thunderbirds were up 1-0 on the Warfield power play goal. Jacob Schnapp would add a power play goal of his own. Goals taking a little bit longer to come by here in the first period of this one. The Batita line with Martin and Devin Warfield on right now for Carolina. Martin has it from the goal line. Skating back down low, going with a wide base there. Keeping the skates apart to try and protect the puck. He's got the puck up top now. Sending that one cross ice for Batita. Out of the corner, Batita. Battles there with White Duck. Moved up and a hit by Batita. But the puck comes all the way back out. Kayan Farsad chipping this one back in. Now he heads for the bench. Talipov to Martin. Back for Talipov. And Cody Oakes. Now Martin will skate it out and advance it for Devin Warfield. Down the left side, a long shot there, catches the glass in behind McEwen. Batita gets to the follow-up chance, kind of chops that puck wide. Now, near side, Warfield going to work there with Daniel Martin against Aaron Atwell. Those two come to the boards, and Martin pulled it off just for a second. Taken away now by Brett Jackson, and the hat trick's Johnny Ruiz tries to poke this one back up to an open spot. Talipov beats him there, though. Chipped off, here's a chance, right in front. Bonella shot, stopped by Paulin. First big chance in a while for the Hat-Tricks. Could kind of feel that one coming. Great heads-up play by Ruiz to find Bonnell in front. Thunderbirds with some trouble on the defensive assignment. Now here comes Hunt back the other way. Shot along the ice, turned out by McEwen. 5.5 to go. First period, Hunt finds Batita. Up top, George Holt walks in, sends one there, it goes wide. Hunt on the rebound, battling for it. Finberg has it. For the Hat-Tricks, can't catch up to it. Jacob Schnapp can't hold the line. And now it's Kuznetsov sidestepping George Holt, but losing the puck. And so Holt wants the stretch pass. Chris Hunt kicks that one up to himself. Pastuga couldn't settle down, and bringing it in offsides, Blake Peavy. Had a full head of steam there. If Pastuga had been able to settle that puck down, it was ducking and diving all over the place. But if he'd been able to settle it down, could have been a solid opportunity for Peavy. Coming about 20 miles an hour through the neutral zone. Jacob Schnapp sees that one played away from him. Dmitry Danilik plays it back in. On and off the tape of Chris Hunt. George Holt now. The defenseman pinching in, and we'll have a stoppage and a penalty. Blake Peavy goes off for an interference call. Thunderbirds shorthanded once again. Peavy in the box as Carolina goes shorthanded for the second time tonight. Bit of a quick play in front of the Carolina bench. Tough to see the contact there. Peavy acting as a roadblock for someone. Second power play opportunity for the Hat-Tricks in this one. 0-7 last night. And in a scoreless game where they have gotten closer and closer to striking gold here. Gordy Bonnell off the Johnny Ruiz feed. Their most recent chance as Bonnell's got the puck now on the near side. Ruiz from the goal line underneath Bonnell. Spun off of Cody Oakes. Bonnell out of the corner, moves it back up top now. Soucy for Bonnell, far side. Once in front, a chance for Ruiz. Sprawled out Chris Paulin, but never had to make a save. Oakes racing after this one against Soucy, and Cody Oakes gets there first. And a whistle and a stoppage again. That puck looked to go off of someone on the Thunderbirds bench. 4.5 to go, first period. Batita, Martin, Pastuga, and George Holt, the penalty killers out there for the Thunderbirds right now. Ruiz and company staying on for the Hat-Tricks. As we've got a bit more here from the scorer's table. Trying to reset the clock. We'll use this as a brief media timeout here. Scoreless from Winston-Salem, 4:26 to go in the first.
Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist helps you do more of the things you love. More laughs, more adventures, more hugs. We combine the brightest minds in medicine to bring you world-class care with a commitment.
Quick pitching us. Didn't have time to get set for that one. 4:13 to go. Hat trick still on the power play. Minute 15 to go. They're trying to work things out of their own end. Daniluk and company coming back on. Out to the near side, Susie. Pittsburgh native. Played for the Vengeance and Junior Penguins back in the mid-2010s. Almost, or also a member of the Battle Creek Rumblebees back in 2018-19 as this one down the left side. Long shot stopped by Paulin. Ruiz, shooter of that puck. Paulin comes out to pounce on that one. Hasn't been tested very often, but Chris Paulin equal to the task. His sixth save of the night. 42 seconds to go on the interference penalty to Blake Peavy. Gus Ford unable to win that one back. Atwell from the point on the power play. Still some time here for Danbury to do some damage. Finberg down low, watched by Pelnick. Moves it back up top. Atwell cross ice for Brown. Brown away from Ford, moving it back down low. Kuznetsov. Kuznetsov from the hash marks. Underneath, Finberg. Backdoor chance up top. Brown, long shot through traffic. Paulin makes the save. Where's the rebound? Goes in behind the goal. Kuznetsov on that one. 15 seconds to go on the power play. Atwell, long drive from the point, high and wide. Paulin didn't see it. Brown shovels it underneath and out of play. They'll rule. Brown trying to say it went off of a Thunderbird. Corey Anderson seeming to argue the same thing. Charlie Pelnick not sure what all the commotion's about. 2:58 to go, first period. Still scoreless, but 6 seconds of power play time remain for the Hat Tricks. Kodiak White Duck stands in against Gus Ford again. Off the collision, and Tommy Cardinal gathers that one and sends it the length of the ice. All the way back and around, Thunderbirds kill it off. Hat tricks 0 for 2 on the power play so far tonight. Atwell with 2:43 to go. First bank, first period. Gus Ford takes the puck away from him. He'll have to go to town there against White Duck and Atwell. Atwell picks it up and flips it off the boards, though. Ramil Talipov keeps it in the zone. His long shot sticked aside by McEwen. Ford on it there to Cardinal in the slot. Backdoor, here's a chance. Pestuka trying to pinch down from his point. Lost the puck, but moves it back up. Brian Moore, center point, winds, fires one off the crossbar again. No goal, play continues. Puck loose in the slot. Hat tricks have it back out to center. Heavy metal shot for the second time tonight. Here comes Moore again. Pestuka poking at that one. That puck seemed to move the entire net as Moore has it again at center. Getting the stick up there. Gus Ford has it down the left side. With Pestuka joining him, Ford tries to slip it for Pestuka. Can't do it there inside 2 minutes. Up top, Ford has lots of room. Moving it back down low. Backhand shot turned aside there by William McEwen. Donahue letting that one go, and the puck comes all the way back out into Thunderbird Realty. Gus Ford able to chop it back in. McClendon checked that. McEwen on the near side. Brett Jackson to stop it. Final 90 seconds. Outmuscled there by Donahue. Pulls the puck free. Moore puts his back to the play. Moves it now to Donahue again. Up top, George Holt waits and moves it now near side Nicoletti. Nicoletti having a joust there with Ruiz. Underneath it goes Brett Jackson, moves things on for Danieluk. And now far side, Gordy Bunnell moving this puck back out. Slow bouncer, collected by Nicoletti, moved up for Brian Moore. Puck comes away from him, kicked ahead there by Kuznetsov. Nicoletti has to skate away from him. Off the boards, turnover. Finberg's shot there, kind of knuckled on its way to the goal. And now Nicoletti, a 3-on-2 back the other way. Schnapp's chance poked off his stick. Peavy has to backhand this one through. Almost a dangerous chance back for Danbury. 45 to go in the first period. Off the boards, taken down the right side. Kuznetsov winds and blasts one, Paul in the save. 38 seconds, Kuznetsov tangles with Pelnick in the back of the play. Delayed call as Paulin touches that one up, delayed offsides, rather. And now Blake Peavy gathering speed, drops it off. Hunt from the top of the circle. Blake Peavy inadvertently blocked it as he got sent down, and that'll be a penalty. Brown will get an interference call on that one. Blake Peavy coming through with a full head of steam. He had already dropped off the puck, and the officials ruling that It was outside of the acceptable time frame to hit Peavy after he had released the puck. So a pair of tripping penalties, one per side. Now a pair of interference penalties, one per side. Carolina's second power play chance of the game. After drawing the penalty, Blake Peavy stands in to take the faceoff against Ruiz. Wins this one back, Pastuca. They've got 20 seconds in the period. Chris Hunt, top of the circles. Pelnick wants it back. Hunt drops it off for him. Ruiz picks a pocket. He read that play perfectly. Here comes Ruiz. Shorthanded against Paulin. Stopped by Paulin. Where's the puck? He makes the save and keeps it out. Chris Paulin, what a stop. Somewhere in his gear, they're having a hard time finding it. Paulin, an unorthodox stop. Keeping one pad up and one pad parallel to the ice. Does the snow angel, but keeps it from going in. Good read by Johnny Ruiz, and Chris Paulin still can't find that puck. It's somewhere in his equipment. Well, it's either still in there or they found it while we weren't looking, and he was just adjusting his equipment. Ready to drop the puck, 6.4. Thunderbirds will just have to kill the last few seconds of this period. They'll still have a minute and 40 seconds of power play time when the second period rolls around. They've outshot the Danbury Hat-Tricks 12-10 through 20 minutes. And they've got a pretty decent opportunity to try and get that game's first goal when we come back with the Modern Automotive second period. Before that, first intermission coming your way on the other side of this break. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So, we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
Maple Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad. Come enjoy a meal at the Pine Brook Bar and Grill. Relax by our pool and cabana. Gear up at the Pro Shop and sharpen your skills on our 9,000 square foot putting green. And play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. Find out more at MapleChaseCC.com.
A lot has changed since 1933, but one thing that hasn't is Modern Automotive's commitment to you. North Carolina car buyers have trusted Modern for 85 years for affordable prices, big selection, and an everlasting commitment to local schools, youth programs, and charitable organizations. It has been our pleasure to earn your business and help make a difference in our community.
Experience the Modern difference. Family owned since 1933.
The Carolina Thunderbirds have a set of two custom wine labels that can be yours to take home today. The Thunderbirds Red and Carolina White are special edition, first-run custom wine labels for Carolina Thunderbirds fans. Bottles are $40 individually and $75 when bought as a set. Call the Thunderbirds office to get yours today, 336-774-4625.
Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist helps you do more of the things you love. More laughs, more adventures, more hugs. We combine the brightest minds in medicine to bring you world-class care with a commitment to strengthen the health and wellness of our community. Because when it comes to the health of you and your family, no one should settle for anything short of life-changing.
After the success of the Vanilla Coffee Porter, the Carolina Thunderbirds and Fiddlin' Fish Brewing Company are back with another instant classic, the Thunderbirds Blonde Ale.
Welcome back to Winston-Salem for the first intermission here from the Fairgrounds Annex. Carolina and Danbury scoreless after 20 minutes. Thunderbirds out shooting the hat tricks 12-9 in that opening frame. Danbury 0-2 on the power play. Carolina in the middle of its second opportunity of the game. Brown in the box, 2 for interference on Blake Peavy. And Carolina starting to set things up and go to work on the power play. But the most notable part of this young power play, again, Carolina still with a minute 40 seconds on it when we return in the second period. But the most notable part of the power play was a shorthanded opportunity for Johnny Ruiz, and that one really showcasing the speed and his ability to read the play. Chris Hunt and Charlie Pelnick tried to do a little give and go, a little backhanded switch there up top at the blue line. A great play if it works. An almost disaster there in this opportunity because it didn't. Johnny Ruiz a bit too experienced to try and do that against him. He read it like a book, skated all the way back down, and Chris Paulin had to make a pretty darn good save. Maybe a second one as well, as Ruiz was crashing the net for a rebound. Paulin does the snow angel, keeps the puck out somewhere in his pads, and keeps us at a scoreless game. But the Thunderbird power play was really the driving force in last night's game. Two power play goals on their way to a 6-3 victory, and the power play will be looked upon to give Carolina a boost. And right now, this is not the same game as last night. We're scoreless right now from Winston-Salem. Thunderbirds don't have a 2 or a 3 goal cushion to operate with, so they'll need to score on this power play or one particularly soon, trying and making the most of their opportunities as they come. And for the hat tricks, if they can get this kill, keep things even, really looking better for them as they try to even up the season series at one game apiece. Right now, Thunderbirds with the lone win in that season series. We'll step aside for a moment, and when we come back, a surprise visitor, Thunderbirds defenseman Vaughn Clouston, joins us up here in the broadcast booth.
Conveniently located at the corner of Rinalda Road and Northwest Boulevard, Salem Smiles and Dr. Sarah C. Schoaf is the preferred orthodontist of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Dr. Schoaf is a Winston-Salem native and a trusted name in orthodontics since 1992. So whether you're on the ice or in the stands, trust your teeth to Dr. Smashmouth and her team at Salem Smiles.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
After the success of the Vanilla Coffee Porter, the Carolina Thunderbirds and Fiddlin' Fish Brewing Company are back with another instant classic, the Thunderbirds Blonde Ale. Smooth and easy drinking, it's the perfect beer for cheering on the birds. Don't delay, these cans are limited edition. Get yours at the game, in the grocery store, or at Fiddlin' Fish on Trade Street.
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist.
A lot has changed since 1933, but one thing that hasn't is Modern Automotive's commitment to you. North Carolina car buyers have trusted Modern for 85 years for affordable prices, big selection, and an everlasting commitment to local schools, youth programs, and charitable organizations. It has been our pleasure to earn your business and help make a difference in our community.
Experience the Modern difference. Family owned since 1933.
Welcome back to Winston-Salem. Scoreless through 20 minutes here between Carolina and the Danbury Hattricks. Dylan Clark with you, and special guest Vaughn Clouston joins the broadcast. Thunderbirds defenseman Vaughn, welcome to the program, first of all, and welcome to Carolina.
Oh, thanks, Stone. I'm glad to be here.
So a bit of a unique perspective for you. Obviously, would rather be down on the ice. But from up here, you get to see a lot more. You get to become really a fan and an observer of the game. What have you noticed through this first 20 minutes?
Well, I noticed that Brian Moore shoots the puck harder than almost anyone I met. I think he almost broke the crossbar twice. But we're definitely jumping on him. We're heading shots, which is usually a good indication of how the game's going. And I think this second period coming out here, we're going to come pretty strong.
We said the same thing up here in the broadcast booth. It actually looked as though the net moved up off its – just a little bit, just tipped back a little bit when Moore shot that puck. How does it change the team atmosphere when you got a guy like that in the lineup?
Just the confidence that he brings in his own play really translates over to a lot of other players. You know, with a guy like that in the lineup that can score goals and can defend teammates really gives guys the liberty to go out there and play the game that they want.
Speaking of guys that give you confidence, Chris Paulin's performance over the last little while, that's got to inspire some confidence in the team, no?
Yeah, that's amazing. You know, coming off of like the bench right there to help out Mandika, it's amazing. You know, you don't really expect to go into a game like that. And once you get thrown in there, it's a gamble, you know. You don't know what's going to happen, but he came out and he played amazing.
You joined the team midway through the road trip through Columbus, former River Dragon yourself, but back here now kind of on the other side of the rivalry. You've gotten a few games here at the Fairgrounds Annex. What can you say about the atmosphere? It really is a unique atmosphere for the league, isn't it?
Yeah, it's definitely better playing here as a Thunderbird than an opponent. But, yeah, no, the fans have always been great to me, whether I've been in a road team or playing here for the Thunderbirds. And after games, it's so special. You get to go down to the beer garden with the fans, and they always want to talk to you. It's awesome.
After a bit of a difficult stretch for the team earlier in the month, is it starting to feel as though things are coming together and you're starting to hit your stride?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, we're definitely coming closer as a team. We're starting to get our gel together. And we're getting some new guys here and there. So you could say we're definitely coming along pretty good and getting some more confidence.
Awesome. Vaughn, thanks so much for being with us. Hey. One more break. Maybe we'll have you on in a little
bit.
Huh?
Hey, thank you so much.
Maybe we'll have you back. You did a good job.
Thank you.
That was Vaughn Clouston, Dylan Clark. We'll be back in a moment with more First Intermission here from Winston-Salem.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app. Presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
Maple Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad. Come enjoy a meal at the Pine Brook Bar and Grill. Relax by our pool and cabana. Gear up at the Pro Shop and sharpen your skills on our 9,000 square foot putting green. And play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. Find out more at MapleChaseCC.com.
A lot has changed since 1933, but one thing that hasn't is Modern Automotive's commitment to you. North Carolina car buyers have trusted Modern for 85 years for affordable prices, big selection, and an everlasting commitment to local schools, youth programs, and charitable organizations. It has been our pleasure to earn your business and help make a difference in our community.
Experience the Modern difference. Family owned since 1933.
The Carolina Thunderbirds have a set of two custom wine labels that can be yours to take home today. The Thunderbirds Red and Carolina White are special edition, first-run custom wine labels for Carolina Thunderbirds fans. Bottles are $40 individually and $75 when bought as a set. Call the Thunderbirds office to get yours today, 336-774-4625.
Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist helps you do more of the things you love, more laughs, more adventures, more hugs. We combine the brightest minds in medicine to bring you world-class care with a commitment to strengthen the health and wellness of our community. Because when it comes to the health of you and your family, no one should settle for anything short of life-changing.
After the success of the Vanilla Coffee Porter, the Carolina Thunderbirds and Fiddlin' Fish Brewing Company are back with another instant classic. the Thunderbirds Blonde Ale. Smooth and easy drinking, it's the perfect beer for cheering on the birds. Don't delay, these cans are limited edition. Get yours at the game, in the grocery store, or at Fiddlin' Fish on Trade Street.
Welcome back to Winston-Salem. First intermission report wrapping up here. Caroline and Danbury scoreless through the first 20 minutes. Thunderbirds will be back on an abbreviated power play, about a minute 40 seconds of man advantage time for Carolina. 3-3 at home. The Thunderbirds' home record on its way up, and Danbury's chances on the road, their road record 2-2-0-1. A mixed bag for both teams, and a place that had really been a strong point for the Thunderbirds over the last few seasons, especially, well, back in 2019-20. That was the last season the Thunderbirds had a schedule at home, again, playing entirely on the road last season. But a source of strength and a kind of a fortress for the Thunderbirds, the Winston-Salem Fairgrounds Annex. So another win in this building, first one since the end of October last night, and they look to build on that one, and they'll start with some early power play time here in this second period. Thunderbirds have moved back up into second place in the FPHL's West Division standings. Things have been completely flipped around there. Port Huron now on top because of the points percentage, Carolina in second, and Columbus back down at third. Columbus was in first just last night. And with those things shuffling around, Thunderbirds with a win tonight have the opportunity to move back up into first place. And all of these things kind of arbitrary at this point in the season. But the old adage, at least in professional hockey, is that the standings around Thanksgiving, American Thanksgiving, are kind of the way things shape out to be come playoff time. You don't really get a ton of movement after that. That can kind of be tweaked a little bit here in the FPHL for a number of reasons. A, because the league starts so much later than some of the other leagues, the ECHL, AHL, and the National Hockey League as well. And for the simple fact that there are only seven teams in the FPHL, so fewer teams means that there's lots more wiggle room and teams can come up, teams can go down, just like the River Dragons from last night to tonight, first in the division to third in the division in the matter of 24 hours. So lots of movement on the horizon, but as we get through, it does become harder and harder to find any sort of movement. So obviously, you want to spend as much time as high up in the standings as you possibly can. Thunderbirds, when they come out for the second period in just a few moments, look to take one more step towards that first place slot with the power play here against the Hat Trick. Scoreless from Carolina. One more break, and we'll be back with the Modern Automotive second period.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So, we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
Family owned and operated since 1938, Mustin and Crutchfield Food Market in Kernersville is the place to find your favorite homemade foods. Sample the finest cuts of meat from our on-site butcher, enjoy a glass bottle of soda like the old days, and go home with a tub of our famous homemade pimento cheese. Come see us at 245 North Main Street in downtown Kernersville.
The Carolina Thunderbirds have a set of two custom wine labels that can be yours to take home today. The Thunderbirds Red and Carolina White are special edition, first-run custom wine labels for Carolina Thunderbirds fans. Bottles are $40 individually and $75 when bought as a set. Call the Thunderbirds office to get yours today, 336-774-4625. Conveniently located at the corner of Rinalda Road and Northwest Boulevard, Salem Smiles and Dr. Sarah C. Schoaf is the preferred orthodontist of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Dr. Schoaf is a Winston-Salem native and a trusted name in orthodontics since 1992. So whether you're on the ice or in the stands, trust your teeth to Dr. Smashmouth and her team at Salem Smiles.
Back in Winston-Salem, the second period brought to you by Modern Automotive, just moments from puck drop. A minute 40 seconds left on this power play for the Carolina Thunderbirds. Steve Brown in the box, 2-4, interfering with Blake Peavy. As the Thunderbirds will move left to right for this one. And Chris Paulin's goal crease receiving some more attention from Paul Jackson and company. And that spot on the ice down by the Zamboni doors has been a spot of some trouble over the last little bit, especially earlier on when the ice was young and not quite as thick and not quite as built up as it currently sits right now. Simply because of all the Zamboni traffic over top of it. Has a bit of a weak spot to it. Just something to keep an eye on and just deal with as things go along. Thunderbirds. We don't have an official attendance figure on the night just yet. Over 2,100 fans came through the doors of the Fairgrounds Annex last night against Danbury. And through the first month and, well, we'll say month and a week of the season, over 14,000 fans have come through the Fairgrounds Annex to see the Carolina Thunderbirds play hockey. Just an incredible asset to have a strong fan base and a hockey-crazed community in the heart of college football and college basketball country. Cody Oaks, Winston-Salem boy right now. Born in Aurora, Colorado, but living in Winston-Salem with his family for the last few years. Hometown kid skates it back in. 19:40 to go in this second period. Shorthanded, the hat tricks come back the other way. They've got some speed and a long shot punched out by Chris Paulin. That one off the stick there as it comes all the way back out in front. Jacob Schnapp has to wave at that one. And Brian Moore brings this back on now for Yuri Pestuka. Thunderbirds trying to get set up here on the power play. Pestuka, near side, Brian Moore. You heard Juan Clouston talk about the heavy shot of Brian Moore. Gus Ford back down low. Jacob Schnapp up top. Ford, top of the circles. Center point, Pestuka. Back for Ford. Wants the shot, sends it across. Moore, a blast there right into the glove. William McEwen makes the save. 19:04 to go. Second period, and you can hear the crowd take a collective gasp there as Moore wound up for that shot. Big opportunity there. 19:04 to go, second period. Brown still in the box for 44 more seconds. Daniluk away from the forecheck of Devin Warfield, so the puck comes back out. Charlie Pelnick, and this one moves near side now for Daniel Martin. Four goals on the season has Martin. This one chipped all the way back out. And down for Chris Paulin to make the stop and guide things around near side Pelnick. 6'5", dropping it back off now for Daniel Martin. Away from Johnny Ruiz, had a good shorthanded opportunity right at the end of the first period, forcing Paulin to make a pretty good save. Batista strides over the line now. Little give and go with Scotty Donahue. Now near side Pelnick, fans on that shot. Now it comes to Martin, back for Pelnick. Penalty just about done here. There's now a chance, here comes Ruiz with Brown out of the box. Ruiz down the right side, finds Brown in front, can't settle it down and gets a backhander. That goes off the side of the goal. Paulin didn't have to make the save. Dangerous opportunity there for the Danbury Hattricks. Thunderbirds counterattack with speed now. Devin Warfield down the left side. Hits the goal line and moves things all the way back under for Daniel Martin. Underneath with Petita. Things slowing down here in this middle frame. George Holt skates in. Sends one on goal. Saved by McEwen. The rebound popped around in front for a little bit. Hattricks come away with it. It's Daniluk. Flipping this puck high and back the other way. Yuri Pestuka gets back. No icing, and he sends a man down. Tal Finberg, a little overexcited, getting after Pestuka. George Holt jousting there with Brett Jackson. Solid stick work by Jackson. He's all over Holt. Holt has that puck pinned to the near side boards. Now it comes free, and it can be taken out here by Jake Schnapp. Schnapp trying to send that one through for Chris Hunt. It goes underneath his stick. He's able to chip this one back now for Schnapp. Bumped off that puck there by Aaron Atwell. Hunt centers one in front. Schnapp, a turning shot turned out there by McEwen. Very similar to Schnapp's goal last night. Quick pass in front, just kind of wheels it around, but keeps it on the ice. Away from Schnapp, the pass by Steve Brown comes to the near side. Hunt's reversal picked off now by Brown. A little more than 3 minutes gone, second period. No score is Atwell. Almost coughed that puck up to a forechecking Chris Hunt. Instead, the hat tricks move it all the way back in. Ramil Talapov to take over for Carolina. To the near side, Cody Oakes up for Chris Hunt. Away from Atwell, moves it on now for Oakes on his backhand. Gains the line away from Corey Anderson. Chips this back in, and Blake Peavy goes to work. He gets taken down by Kuznetsov. Brian Moore away from Anderson, sent down, but moves the puck over to Blake Peavy. Moore slow to get up. Kuznetsov now has his pocket picked. Here's a chance. Donahue darts towards the slot. Has it taken away from him by Anderson. Michael Lopez and company throwing this one in on Paulin's goal from long range. 16 minutes exactly. He makes the save. Hangs on for the faceoff. 15-11 the shots right now. Carolina still leading there. Out of town in the FPHL. Puck drop from Delaware as the Binghamton Black Bears come to visit them is just moments away. And again, the Columbus River Dragons taking on the FPHL's top team in the Watertown Wolves from upstate New York at 7:30. Through neutral ice, Brian Moore collects that one for Carolina. Moving it back now, Charlie Pelnick. Pelnick winds as he gains the red line and blasts that one in on McEwen. Dropped off now, Susie for Daniluk. Daniluk darting through center away from a maze of Thunderbird sticks and skates and puts this one back in behind Paulin's net. Dropped off by Pelnick for David Nicoletti. Nicoletti waiting as Kuznetsov waiting behind the goal. Hat tricks in the trap right now. One forechecker. Four players clogging the neutral zone as a turnover right in front. Here comes Kuznetsov. Backdoor feed. Ruiz couldn't put it home. Dangerous opportunity there. Thunderbirds back now in transition. Moore down the right side. Top of the circles. Finds the trailer in Donahue. Goes off his skates and the hat tricks come back three men strong. Gordy Bunnell down the left side. Lays one out there. Paul in the save. Bunnell gets his own rebound. Back up top. Brown. Chips it underneath Johnny Ruiz. Hattrick's captain finds Bunnell, circling back down low. Danbury's got some jump in their game right now. Right in front, Ruiz. Oh, he scores. What a brilliant feed. Fresh from the bench, Tal Finberg. And the Hattrick's strike first. Danbury, a number of opportunities in quick succession there. Finberg, the beneficiary there as the winger got off and Finberg comes on from the bench in his stead. Stealthily enters the play and no one picked him up. Danbury strikes first in this one. Out to a 1-0 lead. All the way back down for an icing. Ruiz and Brett Jackson getting the assist on the goal there. One more quick break. Media timeout. 1-0. Hattricks lead it here in the second period. Welcome back to the Fairgrounds Annex. 1-0 the score thanks to Johnny Ruiz. An even strength goal from Gordy Bunnell and Brett Jackson. 5:23 into this second period. Carolina trails, but they've got an offensive zone faceoff. Out of the left wing circle, Pestuka. Long wrister. Catches the glass in behind McEwen's goal. Now back out comes Thomas Bell, lifting that one high up into the netting. In behind Paulin's goal. Out of play for a faceoff. Thunderbirds scoring the game's first goal just 24 hours ago. Danbury off to the early lead here, and you saw how much momentum it gave the Thunderbirds, not just last night, but Wednesday night against the River Dragons as well. Danbury, after holding Carolina off the board through the entire first period, killing off a number of penalties as there's a heavy hit by Jacob Schnapp, just getting back to his skates now, Kodiak White Duck. But you saw how much those early goals and getting out ahead early helped the Thunderbirds in their most recent two wins. Danbury taking the wind out of Carolina's sails early in this one. And they look a little disheveled, does Carolina. George Holt in behind Paulin's net. Waved at there by Dmitry Kuznetsov. And Holt sends this one up the wing for Schnapp. Corey Anderson out of his own end. A little flyby from Chris Hunt. Now it's Anderson down the left wing. Anderson with speed sends that one in front. Through the goal mouth. Up off the boards, Vinny Susi's point drive, gloved and held by Paulin. Solid pass through the crease there by the hat tricks. It avoids everybody, but acted as a pretty nice pass back to the point. Vinny Susi able to unload with a pretty heavy shot. Fortunately for Paulin, no traffic in front. He was able to see it all the way through. Anderson and company go back to work here in the offensive end for Danbury. In behind, Cody Oakes. Working this one back out now for the Thunderbirds. Oakes away here from Finberg. Forechecking Kuznetsov picks that one off, but Danbury unable to keep it in the zone. Finberg flips this one on his backhand, and Paulin wastes no time. He'll cover up right away. It'll take a few more seconds off. 12:54 to go, second period. Thunderbirds, after a handful of decent looks in the first, have kind of stalled out here a bit in this second period. John Batita's line comes on now. Try and work this one back out. Batita again, team leader in shots on goal with 35 coming into tonight's game as Daniel Martin sends a backhand pass up for Batita right now. Down the left side, Batita pulls up, trying to protect that puck for Talapov. He does, and it goes up off of a defender and the glass up and out of play into the netting. 12:42, second period. Talapov goes off on a line change. Nicoletti and Pelnik back out, pair of left-handed defensemen. Out on this faceoff for Carolina. Offensive end, Martin been taking more and more faceoffs in this game. David Nicoletti now from the point. Pelnik, one-time shot, turned out by McEwen. Down low, away from Daniel Martin, taken now by Daniluk. All the way back out. Brett Jackson down the right side for Danbury. Tops of the circles, fakes it, cuts across the slot, sends one there on goal, and Paulin makes the save. The shot fooled him a little bit there. He's able to just get a pad on it and smother for a faceoff. Nice work there by Brett Jackson. Again, that head fake, he's able to look off the defenseman, hit the brakes, and cut laterally across the slot, open up that shooting lane for himself. It looked as though when he took the shot, it hit the stick of the defender, maybe something else on its way. He didn't cleanly get the shot away. There's now a chance for Danbury in front, is taken away by Chris Hunt. Hunt sends down Michael Lopez behind the play, is getting to this one. Michael Lopez back out in neutral territory. He and David Nicoletti chop after this one as it rolls back into Carolina's end. Pelnik drops for Peavy. Out of the Carolina zone, Nicoletti down the left side, can't catch up to that puck. And now White Duck comes back. Here's a chance for the hat tricks. White Duck drops it off. Oh, a big hit there. Blake Peavy blindsides Michael Lopez. He's slow to get up. 11:40 to go. Clean hit. And a devastating one at that is all the way around on the near side. Jacob Schnapp lets that one go. Save made as cutting through the crease was Chris Hunt. William McEwen covers now for a faceoff. 11:30 to go in the first. Big hit there by Blake Peavy. Lopez had no chance Didn't see Peavy coming on his blind side. It was shoulder to shoulder. And that hit resulting, after it separates the man from the puck, results in almost a pretty good chance back the other way for Carolina. Gus Ford now to take the offensive zone draw. 11 and a half to go. Holt, cross ice feed, picked off. Here comes Kuznetsov. Another breakaway against Pollin. Kuznetsov deeks and scores. Dmitry Kuznetsov sends Pollin sprawling. It's 2-0 Danbury. Dmitry Kuznetsov, his eighth goal of the season, ties him for first on the team with Corey Anderson at 8. Johnny Ruiz up there as well, as he scored his eighth goal of the year earlier on in this second period. So a 2-0 game, and the Thunderbirds find themselves in a bit of a rut right now. Kuznetsov's goal unassisted. As now Paulin out of his net to play this one. Thunderbirds looking for a spark, but instead they turn the puck over. Brett Jackson sends it towards the goal. Deflected on its way. Now taken by Ford. Gives this one up for Brian Moore. He's got a step. Brian Moore with speed down the right side. Nice move between his legs. Backdoor pass. Oh, what a chance. Almost fed Devin Warfield. Moore feeling the confidence here. Looking to give Carolina that spark. Nearly did it with a dazzling play. Talipov. Around the near side, Brian Moore takes this one back at center. Moore spins around in the neutral zone. Can't get that one through Kodiak White Duck, and he'll flip this one all the way back into Carolina's end. Talipov after it here. Stepped into by Anderson, and this one moved around Gus Ford and Cody Oakes on it here. White Duck jumps in and intercepts. Throws that one through the slot, but nobody in a white sweater was home. Devin Warfield now collects and strides this one back out to center. Warfield dumping this one back in, and delayed offsides. Thunderbirds will have to go back to the bench. In the neutral zone, this one chipped back into Danbury territory. White Duck moving it across now. Brown up for Kuznetsov, most recent goal scorer for the hat tricks. Martin zone exit pass deflected away, and here comes Yuri Peshtuka with some speed. Peshtuka, one hand, draws a penalty. Touched up now by the hat tricks, and that whistle blows the play dead. Yuri Peshtuka, full head of steam coming in on this one. Thunderbirds to the power play. They trail 2-0. That man advantage will come up right after this break.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today. Sometimes, we all need a bit of help. Come on. That's where North Carolina Golf Academy comes
in. The penalty box for the hat tricks. Thunderbirds on their third power play of the game, a hooking call. First penalty of the second period. No better time for Carolina to get back after it here. They trail by 2 and have looked a bit stale here in the second period. Chris Hunt now to the corner. It just takes one as this one flipped back out. Yuri Peshtuka gathers between the hash marks for the Thunderbirds. Peshtuka's pass intended for Schnapp. It escapes him and Chris Hunt as well. All the way back underneath, Charlie Pelnick together. Pelnick near side, Peavy. Across the line, drops now for Pelnick. He's got Peshtuka on the far wing, and that puck back in his skates, so Peshtuka's got to stop up and just chip it into the zone. Cleared back out to center. Charlie Pelnick on this one. Pelnick back for Peshtuka. 40 seconds gone already on the man advantage. Thunderbirds still haven't registered a shot. Here comes Peavy. Blake Peavy coughs it up. Kuznetsov looking after that one. Hat-tricks have it now just inside the line. Corey Anderson. Peavy trying to work this one away from Kuznetsov. Throws one through the slot. Peshtuka back for Pelnick. Now Chris Hunt. Thunderbirds break into the offensive zone. Hunt immediately has his pocket picked. Puck sent down the length of the ice. Second power play unit comes up now. Cody Oakes. Oakes across center red with some speed now. Oakes down the right side. 40 seconds on the power play. Pulls up and hits Schnapps. In the slot, he fanned on that attempt. Near side, Oakes again. Back for Schnapp in the slot. Wasn't ready for it. Follow-up chance. That one hit a defender on its way. Finberg. Stripped of control by Petita. Off the skate of Schnapp. Up top. Moved across by Donahue. Oakes sends it back for Donahue. Has that one taken away. And now a shorthanded chance back for Brett Jackson. But he trips in neutral ice. Fortunate break for the Thunderbirds there. 12 seconds on this power play. Gus Ford drops it off for Chris Paulin. Taking it away from Paulin, and now Ford up through center. 2 seconds and one penalty time expires. Thunderbirds 0-3 on the night. Neither team able to use the man advantage to their advantage, as here comes Johnny Ruiz for Danbury. Lots of time and space in the slot. Here's a chance, back down. Ford back the other way. Petita down the right side with some speed, though. Offsides as the whistle goes. 7:18 to go in this second period, brought to you by Modern Automotive. Shots even at 17 apiece, but goals by Johnny Ruiz and Dmitry Kuznetsov have Danbury out ahead by two. Hat tricks again. As advertised, you know the key players, you know the dangerous scorers, and two of them have converted already tonight for the visitors. Yuri Pastuka's shot, that fell to man. Brown hobbling after taking that one low off the boot. Pastuka's turning shot, gloved and held there by McEwen. Pastuka tried to surprise him with a quick wrister. McEwen was ready. A lot of times you see some goaltenders with the puck down at that angle. They'll go down into the reverse VH on the goalpost. Going down and putting a pad against it, they give away the top of the net. Not the case here from McEwen. Stays up and makes a solid glove save as the Thunderbirds hold it in. Charlie Pelnick's shot. Double deflection on its way. Hits the goal. Hits the glass in behind the goal and moved back out. Pastuka battles for it there with Michael Lopez. Tommy Cardinal back on the ice looking to provide a physical spark. This one moved back out. Too far for Devin Warfield. Back out through center. Pops off the stick of Pelnick. Here comes a chance. 2-on-1 for Danbury. Poked away nicely by Pastuka. Tommy Cardinal has to skate around Charlie Pelnick. Cardinal lost possession, got sent down there by Atwell. And here comes Danbury down the right side. Long shot off the stick of Paulin, deflected up and out of play. So right now, the Hat Tricks content to kind of sit back, let the Thunderbirds try and work their way out of the defensive zone. But the forecheck and the trap in the neutral zone really holding Carolina at bay. Shots 8-7 Danbury in the second period. Hat tricks severely limiting what Carolina's been able to do in the offensive end. Shot up off the glass, held in by Susie. Away from Finberg, couldn't be handled. As now Cody Oakes finds Blake Peavy. At the line, Blake Peavy. Trying to send this one back down low, the cycle for Jake Schnapp. And now Chris Hunt tries to reach in after that one. Hunt separated from the puck by Daniluk. Held in by Cody Oakes. Finds Peavy. High slot. Let's it go. Save made by McEwen. Rebound. Oh, McEwen robs Schnapp. A broken play in front. He didn't get a clean shot away. But that puck was almost knocked over the goal line. McEwen had to make a solid stop. .551 to go in the second. Carolina trailing by two. They've got an offensive zone faceoff. Blake Peavy stands in to take this one. Carolina a bit of light here in the second period as that puck comes back out over the line through Pelnick's feet. Move back in as there's a broken stick down on the ice. Peavy gets taken down after being fed by Schnapp. Still down in the corner. Chris Hunt after this one. It's kicked free by White Duck. And now back out, Gordy Bunnell. Tried to drag a foot and keep that puck with him, and he does. Bunnell, long wrister, easily gloved there by Paulin and held for a faceoff. 5:25 to go. So after one of the quicker games of the season for the Thunderbirds, this game slowing down, lots of whistles, lots of face-offs here in the second period. Danbury just trying to hang on to that 2-0 lead. Just kind of drown the Thunderbirds in a forecheck. Right now, Gus Ford has it out through center. Ford chips this one back in. Brown around now for Atwell, and Danbury moving this one up to far side. Cody Oakes takes a shoulder up high from White Duck. Brown without a stick. Just kind of glove this one back up, and they'll rule delayed offsides here. White Duck coughs it up. Brian Moore back on the ice for Carolina. Flipped up in the bouncing puck, caught up to now by Talipov. Icing called with 4:47 to go. 2-0 here. Danbury leads from Carolina. We'll take a brief media timeout here on the Thunderbirds Hockey Network.
After the success of the Vanilla Coffee Porter, the Carolina Thunderbirds and Fiddlin' Fish Brewing Company are back with another instant classic, the Thunderbirds Blonde Ale. Get yours at the game, in the grocery store, or at Fiddlin' Fish on Trade Street.
Welcome back to Winston-Salem. Late stages of the second period. Carolina trails the Danbury Hatricks 2-0. Johnny Ruiz and Dmitry Kuznetsov, the goal scorers for Danbury. William McEwen made all 21 saves so far tonight. As Atwell moves this one up the far side, as Finberg can't hold it in, Thunderbirds punch it and go back to work. Donahue centering that one there for Moore. Bouncing puck, squeaks through Yuri Pastuka at the line. He'll take a penalty, 2-on-1, back the other way for Danbury. Quick shot stopped by Paulin. And Pastuka was caught flat-footed, didn't have much of a choice. Gets the stick in around the midsection of Tal Finberg as he blew past him. Danbury's third opportunity of the night. Interference, the call on Pastuka, not a hook. Danbury's third power play opportunity. Kuznetsov, hat tricks, went 0-for-7 last night. Chance number three, Kuznetsov, one of the goal scorers, moving this one back down low for Finberg. A nice move away from Talipov. And Finberg back up top, working the perimeter. Brown on this one. Couple of hat tricks right next to each other. Kuznetsov works that one, tried to find the seam. Daniel Martin chopping that puck away from Finberg. Back up top, Atwell fakes the shot, moving it back down low. Working up, Atwell, center point. Long wrister, pad saved by Paulin, and off the scramble, he covers for a faceoff. Not too many fireworks in this one. Thought we'd see a bit more carryover from last night. The animosity ramped up as play went on. Thunderbirds and hat tricks a bit more laid back tonight. For Carolina, maybe that could be the answer, though not right now with the player already in the box. One of your best defensemen down for 2 minutes. But a physical spark could be what the Thunderbirds need to get back into this one. Move back down low, Johnny Ruiz. Shut down by George Holt. Cody Oakes able to clear the zone here. 50 seconds gone on the interference penalty to Yuri Pastuka. 3:30 to go in the second. And this second period brought to you by Modern. Tommy Cardinal couldn't shut that puck down. And all the way back around, Cody Oakes after it. Up the wall. Thunderbirds clear the zone. Hattrick's trying to go back to work. Here comes Gordy Bunnell over the line and offsides. Brett Jackson got a little over-anxious there. Hattrick's power play not able to generate too many shots. Still with tons of zone time, though. Keeping things alive in the offensive end, threatening that third goal. Anderson off the neutral zone faceoff. Brown through center, rimming this one all the way around the horn. Finberg on it there out of the right wing corner. He's on with Corey Anderson. Anderson taking the boards by Ramil Talipov. Finberg on it now. Up the near side wall, Anderson. Finberg back across center red. Does a little loop at center and tries to carry it in himself. That play rejected by Charlie Pelnick. 13 seconds until Yuri Pestuka is free. Hattricks slowing things down to a crawl here. 2 seconds and one. Yuri Pestuka is out. Thunderbirds kill it off as this one brought in on an offsides again. Thunderbirds a little overexcited as they kill off the penalty. Second meeting between these two teams. Danbury leads the season, or the all-time series, 5 wins in regulation, an overtime win, and just 2 losses to the Thunderbirds. Ninth meeting between these two clubs as Paulin chips this one around. He takes a bit of contact as we hit the 2-minute mark here from Winston-Salem. Schnapp, stretch pass down the left side. Brian Moore, what can he do with it? Flying down the wing, sharp angle try. Turned out there by McEwen. Schnapp after it, loose puck, rolls up to the point. George Holt sends it underneath now for Gus Ford. Moore on it. Walks and tries to backhand a puck now for George Holt. Puck comes back to Moore, but poked back out to George Holt and now Cody Oakes. Moore getting tangled with White Duck there, almost a too many men on the ice penalty. Thunderbirds had 2 players hop over that puck. Is now in behind the goal. Ford finds Moore. 1.5 minutes to go. Second period, Moore waiting patiently. Now he finds Cody Oakes. A chance, a shot. He scores! Cody Oakes! Thunderbirds cut the deficit in half. It's 2-1. Goals in back-to-back games for Cody Oakes. This time there was a goaltender in the way. Didn't make a difference. Oakes fires it low to the blocker's side of McEwen. And the Thunderbirds finally knock the goose egg off the board. Brian Moore, great vision to find Oakes on that weak side. And now things have a bit more life here. As Johnny Ruiz breaks this one in right in front. Paulin sweeping after this one. Oh, full split. Paulin made the save with the right pad. Danbury almost taking the win right back out of Carolina's sails. Back over Warfield. Long shot low to the glove side. Blake Peavy from the near side boards around Warfield. Final minute of the period. Taken away. Chris Hunt through the slot. Chopped off his stick. Johnny Ruiz throws that one again off the boards. And now here's a chance. Brett Jackson in on Paulin and he makes the stop. End to end, 42 seconds to go. Cody Oakes on this one. Backhands it for Pestuka. Now Oakes again. He's got some time and space for the Thunderbird breakout. Tough pass there for Blake Peavy. But somehow the Thunderbirds advance that one on now for Batita. He steps in down the right side. Sharp angle chance. Batita may have caught the outside of the goalpost there. McEwen misjudged the angle on it. Final 15 seconds in the second period. Cody Oakes airs one out here all the way to the far side. Scotty Donahue couldn't catch up to that one. Kuznetsov through center. Final 5 seconds. Collision as they come in. Chance right through the slot there for Finberg goes by the wayside. And time expires here in the second. So 2 goals for Danbury. 1 for the Thunderbirds right at the end of the frame. Ruiz and Kuznetsov for the visitors. And it was Cody Oakes for the hometown Thunderbirds. 2-1, some back and forth play, but Carolina ending on a high note here. We'll take a break, and when we come back, Pine Tree Tavern second intermission report here on the Thunderbirds Hockey Network.
Conveniently located at the corner of Rinalda Road and Northwest Boulevard, Salem Smiles and Dr. Sarah C. Schoaf is the preferred orthodontist of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Dr. Schoaf is a Winston-Salem native and a trusted name in orthodontics since 1992. So whether you're on the ice or in the stands, trust your teeth to Dr. Smashmouth and her team at Salem Smiles.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
After the success of the Vanilla Coffee Porter, the Carolina Thunderbirds and Fiddlin' Fish Brewing Company are back with another instant classic. The Thunderbirds Blonde Ale. Smooth and easy drinking, it's the perfect beer for cheering on the birds. Don't delay, these cans are limited edition. Get yours at the game, in the grocery store, or at Fiddlin' Fish on Trade Street.
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist.
A lot has changed since 1933, but one thing that hasn't is Modern Automotive's commitment to you. North Carolina car buyers have trusted Modern for 85 years for affordable prices, big selection, and an everlasting commitment to local schools, youth programs, and charitable organizations. It has been our pleasure to earn your business and help make a difference in our community.
Experience the Modern difference. Family owned since 1933.
Sometimes, we all need a bit of help. Come on. That's where North Carolina Golf Academy comes in.
Let me give you a little tip.
With four instructors ready to get your game to the next level, we're open to the public. Practice on our fully lit driving range and gear up at our pro shop. We're a proudly licensed Callaway dealer. Give us a call at 336-884-4653 and visit us.
Welcome back to Winston-Salem for the Pine Tree Tavern second intermission report. 40 minutes in the books, and after a scoreless first period, it would be the Danbury Hat Tricks breaking the ice. Johnny Ruiz and Dmitry Kuznetsov would come up with a pair of even strength goals for the Hat Tricks to put them firmly in front. It was Ruiz who had that close call at the end of the first period, intercepting a pass up top at the blue line by the Thunderbirds for a brilliant shorthanded chance back the other way. Ruiz would waste only five minutes to score that first goal of the game, 5 minutes into that second period, putting the Hat Tricks in front. And again, Kuznetsov on a breakaway of his own back the other way. Solid head fake and slamming on the brakes right in front of Chris Paulin, sliding it easily around him. And that would be the score for the majority of the second period. Carolina chasing play for long stretches of that period. Danbury content to just sit back and wait and let the Thunderbirds come to them, really throwing monkey wrench after monkey wrench into the Thunderbirds' breakout plans. Carolina not able to muster a ton of opportunities in that period, but they would break through at the end of the frame. Brian Moore, after a broken play, was able to settle the puck down, throw it cross ice to the weak side. Cody Oakes was breaking down that right wing, and Cody Oakes fired his second goal in as many games, second goal in the Thunderbirds uniform, low to the stick-hand side of the goaltender McEwen, and that's got us to 2-1 right now. Thunderbirds a bit shaky in that second period, but the goal by Oakes is kind of the light spot at the end of the tunnel that was that second period, so the goal now is to build on that. Come out strong in the third period. Thunderbirds 0-3 on the power play so far in tonight's game. Should they get more opportunities, they will certainly look to build on that and take that goose egg off the board after they've already taken one off the main scoreboard. 2-1 now through 40 minutes. A quick break for those of you watching on Thunderbirds TV, an episode of Kid Sticks brought to you by Atrium Health. And those of you listening on the Thunderbirds Radio Network, a brief break. We'll be back after this.
Hey, Carolina Thunderbirds fans. This is Kelly Curl here with goaltender Chris Paulin. And today what we're going to do is we're going to go over a couple of things that our goaltenders have to do day in and day out as they get ready to play on the weekend. So real quick, just a walkthrough on Chris Paulin's gear here. He's got his glove and his blocker and his leg pads. Those are the three biggest bulk items. We've got his helmet here, which has got to be able to stand up to all kinds of shots. He's got a Bauer stick here that he uses to control pucks and put pucks in the corners. And then the biggest piece are his pants here that you can't really see. These pants keep his thighs, hips, and his growing area all protected throughout the course of a game. So what we're going to do is we're going to see Paul in here in his basic stance. And then if you'll notice, as he goes into his stance, his gloves are nice and forward. His stick is out in front so that way he can control a puck to the corner if he needs to. And you'll notice that his hips are nice and bent. That's what gives him good knee flexion and the ability to move left or right if he has to. So Chris's biggest movements here are going to be shuffles. So if you'll shuffle right for me here. And then we're going to see a T push back. And those are the most effective ways for Chris to move around the crease. As he moves forward and backwards, we call that depth, where he'll use C cuts to move in and out of the crease. So we'll see a C cut up, good. And let's see a C cut to a T push to the top. C cut up, T push to the top, great. So the biggest saves that we're gonna see Chris make, he's gonna try and do as much as he can with this glove, because it's gonna allow him to control all of his rebounds. That's the number one play after he makes the initial save. His blocker, he'll also use to put pucks in the corner. And then this area here, this box in the middle, we're actually gonna use this to swallow as many pucks as we can. And before we get to see Chris in action here, here's a word from our sponsor.
Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist helps you do more of the things you love. More laughs, more adventures, more hugs. We combine the brightest minds in medicine to bring you world-class care with a commitment to strengthen the health and wellness of our community. Because when it comes to the health of you and your family, no one should settle for anything short of life-changing.
So now what we're going to see here is we're going to see a couple of different save selections. I'm going to shoot a couple into his hands. We're going to watch for good rebound control, pucks going into the corners, pucks being controlled by the glove. And then I'm also going to shoot a couple low into the midsection, where we'll see Chris use the butterfly save to actually control those rebounds. So here we go. We're gonna go blocker here. And we can see Chris is leaving all of these pucks nice and in the corner. No rebound, that's absolutely perfect. That's what we're trying to accomplish. Once again, rebound still to the corner. That's what we're trying to avoid. That's the hardest part for a goaltender to control, is when a puck hits that low knee pad area. In an ideal world, we hope to control those rebounds. We hope we have defensive support. But at the end of the day, Chris is going to make big saves. And we're not going to give up any rebounds. For myself, Chris Paul, and the entire staff here, thanks for watching this episode of Kid Sticks. Thank you to our sponsor, Atrium Health, and we look forward to seeing you this weekend. Thanks.
On the score after 40 minutes here, Danbury leading the Carolina Thunderbirds, and a familiar face spotted around the glass here at the Winston-Salem Fairgrounds Annex. You guessed it, that is former play-by-play voice of your Thunderbirds, Drew Blevins, currently the same position with the Fayetteville Marksman. Fayetteville off tonight, so Drew thought he'd come and give us a surprise visit. Drew joined by his wife Megan, an integral part of this organization for a number of years here, coming in at the beginning of 2019-2020. On a personal note, Drew, extremely helpful in my own development as a broadcaster and bringing me into the fold here in Carolina. Extremely grateful for the time that he's given to me, and good to see a familiar face in the crowd. Drew watching right now a 2-1 hockey game, his former Thunderbirds trailing Danbury by one right now. Again, Cody Oakes has the most recent and only goal for the Thunderbirds, his first goal that wasn't on an empty net. And Cody Oakes has been getting closer and closer as the games have gone on. Hit the goal post on an empty net Wednesday night, scored on an empty net last night, has a goal on a goaltender tonight. So the sky the limit for Cody Oaks right now as he improves his scoring touch. And Oaks has been a player regarded by both head coach Garrett Rutledge and Thunderbirds general manager Kelly Curl as a player with tremendous amounts of upside, he's projected to be a solid player in this league, lots of potential. And again, as Oaks finds more and more comfort on the blue line, finds more and more his game and the things that work for him. You see, he's already got the speed and he's got the tools. As he sharpens that hockey IQ and kind of tones in those skills, Oaks expected to be a dangerous player on the blue line for Carolina. And you heard Coach Rutledge talk about it in the pregame interview. Oaks, a beloved figure in the locker room, always has a smile on the face when he comes into the office to talk to any of the office staff as well. Always has a smile on his face, and it's infectious every single time. Another break here, and when we come back, we'll recap the second period and tell you what to look forward to in the third, as well as give you an update on the out-of-town scoreboard and the other happenings in the FPHL when we're back with more Thunderbirds hockey.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
Maple Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad. Come enjoy a meal at the Pine Brook Bar and Grill. Relax by our pool and cabana. Gear up at the Pro Shop and sharpen your skills on our 9,000 square foot putting green. And play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. Find out more at MapleChaseCC.com.
A lot has changed since 1933, but one thing that hasn't is Modern Automotive's commitment to you. North Carolina car buyers have trusted Modern for 85 years for affordable prices, big selection, and an everlasting commitment to local schools, youth programs, and charitable organizations. It has been our pleasure to earn your business and help make a difference in our community.
Experience the Modern difference. Family owned since 1933.
The Carolina Thunderbirds have a set of two custom wine labels that can be yours to take home today. The Thunderbirds Red and Carolina White are special edition, first-run custom wine labels for Carolina Thunderbirds fans. Bottles are $40 individually and $75 when bought as a set. Call the Thunderbirds office to get yours today, 336-774-4625.
Atrium Health.
Welcome back to Winston-Salem Pine Tree Tavern, second intermission. Carolina trailing Danbury 2-1 after two periods, and the Thunderbirds better as the second period went on, scoring that late goal. Cody Oaks sending that one home, but the Thunderbirds still in need of a spark. If you put tonight's game next to last night's game, two very different looking styles, two very different looking approaches. The Thunderbirds have not come out with the same jump that they found last night. And it's to be expected. The Thunderbirds scored the first two goals in that game, and they were coming off a night of rest, coming off a night of Thanksgiving dinner. Some full stomachs there and some high spirits heading into last night's game. But again, the Thunderbirds are a bit short on that spark and that fire, at least coming out here through two periods. So not to say that that couldn't change on a dime. We saw some big hits in that game. Blake Peavy providing a spark with a hit on a back check there, never seen by the player who discovered it, or who felt it, I should say. And Tommy Cardinal, again, a player we've talked about how he's been upping his physical game as time goes on. The Thunderbirds will look to those two players. Charlie Pelnick as well, 6'5", again, a big defenseman for the Thunderbirds, known to throw his weight around. They'll look to those players to slowly start to chip away at Danbury. And again, the third period has what's been the maker or the breaker of the Thunderbirds over the last little while here. Some sloppy third periods led to Carolina's downfall in Columbus, and some strong ones last night and Wednesday night in Columbus shored up a victory for them. So big 20 minutes coming up here for Carolina. It's a one-goal game. Things could change very quickly, but Carolina needs to be proactive in forcing that change. One last break, and when we come back, third period coming your way on the Thunderbirds Hockey Network.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
Family owned and operated since 1938, Mustin and Crutchfield Food Market in Kernersville is the place to find your favorite homemade foods. Sample the finest cuts of meat from our on-site butcher, enjoy a glass bottle of soda like the old days, and go home with a tub of our famous homemade pimento cheese. Come see us at 245 North Main Street in downtown Kernersville.
The Carolina Thunderbirds have a set of two custom wine labels that can be yours to take home today. The Thunderbirds Red and Carolina White are special edition, first-run custom wine labels for Carolina Thunderbirds fans. Bottles are $40 individually and $75 when bought as a set. Call the Thunderbirds office to get yours today, 336-774-4625.
Welcome back to Winston-Salem. Third period brought to you by Newco Motors coming your way. Carolina trails Danbury 2-1 after 40 minutes. Head coach Garrett Rutledge looking to guide his team to what would be a third consecutive win. Thunderbirds will need to dig deep in this third period if they want to walk out of here with three more points against Danbury. Dave McIsaac of the Hat Tricks looking to walk out of here with 3 points of his own. First-year head coach for the Hat Tricks. 394 AHL games as a player. Calder Cup champion in 1998 with the Philadelphia Phantoms. Played for a number of other AHL teams. Lowell, Kentucky, Hartford. A little bit of time in Hershey. Head coach of the Danbury Mad Hatters in the EPHL. Louisiana Ice Skaters of the Southern Professional Hockey League as well. Now in his first year, back in Danbury, first year with the Hat Tricks, as down and underway in the third period, Daniel Martin lost his stick in the skates of an official. No carryover penalties or power plays in this one. Daniel Martin over the line here. Starts out with John Batita in front. Oh, a big chance with Tommy Cardinal. Batita send it up over the bar. Danbury countering. Finberg away from a hit from Daniel Martin. Pestuka. Fresh sheet of ice. He skates this one up himself. Martin can't corral that puck. Sends a check against Brown. This one moved back in, and Danbury able to control it. Aaron Atwell in his own end. Atwell collects and dumps this one back in behind Paulin's goal. Paulin, 21 saves so far in tonight's game. 17 saves on 17 shots last night, coming in relief of Nick Modica. Cross-ice saucer pass from Pestuka, guided on from Moore to Donahue. Headed towards the goal, chip back underneath. Gus Ford on it now. Moore, turnaround shot, oh, and a glove save by McEwen. Didn't even see it until it was already in his glove. Gives Moore a little how do you do. A minute and 11 seconds gone in this Newco Motors third period. McEwen keeps the score at 2-1. Off the draw, Gus Ford moves it on for Moore. Moore hesitates, back out up top, cutting down the slot. Moore draws a penalty as the Hat Tricks move this one back out into the neutral zone. Brian Moore lost his stick, lost his balance, and the Hat Tricks will lose a player to the penalty box. Thunderbirds back to the power play here. Opportunity number 4 on the night. Both teams still looking for the first power play goal of the game. Gordy Bunnell in the box. Two for tripping against Moore, and the Thunderbird power play goes back to work. And this one chopped down by Charlie Pelnick. Moved back on here by Brett Jackson. Long shot easily gloved and held by Paul, and he wanted to move that puck. Tried to give Brett Jackson a bit of a stutter step there from his butterfly. Couldn't do it, and he'll be forced to hang on for a faceoff. Ruiz to take the offensive zone draw while shorthanded. Gus Ford trying to muscle him out. Both players go down. Pelnick able to guide this one on now for Pestuka. Yuri Pestuka quarterbacking this breakout. Gus Ford dropping things back for Pestuka. Hat tricks, forechecking while shorthanded. Pelnick drops for Moore. Thunderbirds have the zone. And Moore tries to put Jackson in the spin cycle, and he accidentally cleared the zone. Brian Moore, a backhand feed on now for Gus Ford. Ford from the hash marks. Up top, fresh from the bench, Talipov. Emil Talipov with a minute 12 to go on the power play. Thunderbird's fourth chance of the game. Top power play in the FPHL as that one heads up. Goes off a stick and out into some fans. 17:45 to go. We'll rule that that came out off of a deflection from a Thunderbird stick. And so that'll be a neutral zone draw. Peavy and Hunt seem to think that it should be in the Thunderbird's end. That rules a deflection. They'll say it went off a hat trick stick. So it will be an offensive zone draw. Fortunate break for Carolina here. Won't have to waste any time trying to break the puck back into the zone. They're already there. Peavy on this draw. Pelnick and Pestuka at the points. Hunt and now Jacob Schnapp at the wings. Puck gathered by Corey Anderson, trying to be thrown the length of the ice, but Pelnick in the way. He's able to guide it back for Pestuka in the neutral zone. Away from Anderson, Jacob Schnapp now. Chips this one in behind McEwen, got to be careful here. Hunt rims it around, all the way up the horn it comes. Pestuka, long shot in front. Deflected, it comes to rest in the near corner. Jacob Schnapp takes a stick up high, he's still down. Hunt trying to throw this one around. Just now to his feet is Schnapp. Took a stick to the midsection, it looked like. Pestuka can't hold the line. Schnapp looking for a line change here. He's still doubled over in pain. 25 seconds on the power play. Hunt finds Peavy. Trying to come in with speed, couldn't do it. Talipov now. Just hits the red line and throws this one back in. Chris Hunt had to wait. Now he's on his way in with Martin. Martin down low, wanted a pass back through the slot. 10 seconds to go. Talipov. Last chance, long drive, tipped on its way. McEwen made the save. Petita got the stick involved there on that one. Back underneath, Daniel Martin away from Soucy. Power play expires. Martin sent that one through the goal mouth. No one home, but Petita's on it now. In below, Talipov, one of the one-time shot, thrown in front. That one evades the stick of Martin. Devin Warfield on it now. Backdoor feed, wanted Talipov, couldn't get a shot. A follow-up chance, and McEwen made the pad save. Petita up top, Warfield long shot, easily gloved and held. McEwen on that one. 16-16 to go, third period. Thunderbirds TV will keep you with us on the Thunderbirds Radio Network. Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. Offensive zone draw here. Gus Ford unable to win that one. Back at five aside. George Holt stands on now, drops back for Pestuka and on for Gus Ford again. 4 minutes gone in the third period. Thunderbirds trail by one. Goals by Ruiz and Kuznetsov for Danbury as a player down behind the play. Soucy doubled over in pain. He is not getting back up. And we've got a scrap in the corner. Brian Moore throwing some fists here with Daniluk. Brian Moore, Daniluk finally gets the other glove off. Moore throwing haymakers up over the top. Brian Moore has Daniluk by the jersey, and he is going to town here. Jersey comes off of Daniluk. Moore still throwing some more. Connects twice. Brian Moore getting taken into the glass. A heavyweight fight here in the hat trick's end. Still on their feet. Moore pounds away with an uppercut and a right hook of his own. And down goes Daniluk. What a scrap there by Brian Moore. He welcomes himself back to the Fairgrounds Annex. As Vinny Susi just now getting back to his skates here. Daniluk and Moore in the box for the fight. .15:56 to go in this Newco Motors third period. Trying to take a look here as to what happened. The Susi collision a bit behind the play. As things came back over the line, John Batita signaling to the bench right now that they'll skate five on five, but the scorers are waving the officials back over to the penalty box area. This will take a moment to be sorted out. Danbury and Carolina 2-1. We'll take a quick break while this all gets sorted out. Media timeout here. Thunderbirds Trail 2-1 from Winston-Salem.
Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist helps you do more of the things you love. More laughs, more adventures, more hugs. We combine the brightest minds in medicine to bring you world-class care with a commitment to strengthen the health and wellness of our community. Because
back here off the offensive zone faceoff for the hat tricks. Well, we've gotten sorted out what happened to Vinny Susi as the hat tricks have a 5-minute power play. Brian Moore gave him the old spear to the midsection. And no question, Moore would have to fight for that one. Moore 5 for fighting, and Hattricks will break this one out of their own end. Atwell moving back over for Brown. Anderson down the right side again. Anderson back up top. Center point. Brown. Moore fight and 5 for spearing. Chance right in front. Paulin forced to make a good save, and Pestuka able to clear this one the length of the ice. Moore lucky he didn't get more on that one. As through the neutral zone, Danbury's got this one. Tommy Cardinal back in. They'll come and chip it all the way back around. McEwen able to stop this one. Big penalty kill here for the Thunderbirds. On the major penalty to Brian Moore. Danbury can score as many goals as possible in the 5 minutes, and the penalty won't come off the board. So this is an opportunity for the hat tricks to really break away, though if the Thunderbirds can kill it off, as Tommy Cardinal takes a hat trick to the boards back in deep in that zone. If the Thunderbirds can kill it off, that'd be a big momentum swing, as Chris Pauling gloves this one, and he wanted to move it again, or at least acted as though he wanted to move it. 3:22 on the power play here for Danbury. 14:17 to go, third period. We'll keep you right here on this one. Again, Moore and Dana look on that fight. Brian Moore, no stranger to dropping the gloves here in this one, as he's waved over an official for that conversation. Chris Paulin holding down the fort in the Carolina goal to our right. Hattricks power play. This is their fourth opportunity in this hockey game. Again, no power play goals to speak of so far in this one. William McEwen keeping things closed down at his end as well. Again, just his second FPHL game. Frankie McClendon, the goaltender in last night's contest. 5 goals on 43 shots for him. Former Thunderbird on the bench tonight for the hat tricks. Defensive zone draw, Thunderbird still. 3 minutes and some change to kill off. Jackson, all kinds of time, wanted that seam pass and he finds it. Kuznetsov on the back door. Back near side, Jackson, lots of time. Feeds Kuznetsov again, they like that seam. Back up top, Brown, Kuznetsov. Left wing circle, striding away from Peavy. Center point, Brown. Winds and fires a one-timer. Oh, a double deflection on the way. Paulin made the save. Jackson shot that one off of Kodiak White Duck in front. And now Finberg has this one. 2:47 to go on the power play. Moore in the box, a major penalty for spearing on top of five for fighting. Jackson up top, backdoor. Kuznetsov backdoor again. Pass, Paulin made the save. Double backdoor pass. They send it right through the goal crease, and Paulin robs Finberg. And now Cody Oakes clears it the length of the ice. Thunderbirds hanging on here. 13:15 to go. Newcomb owners, third period. Danbury power play looking to break things out. John Batita looking to stop that breakout, and he nearly does. Good job by Batita slowing things down there, and chopped back in by Yuri Peshtuka. McEwen out to drop things off. Danbury power play starts again. Atwell up the far side now, motoring on through center, Gordy Bunnell. Bunnell down the left wing, finds the captain, Johnny Ruiz, off his stick. Jackson fakes the shot, walks in, waiting, now below the goal line, comes out on the near side, and the wrap chance is swept aside by Paulin. Yuri Peshtuka crashes into the boards, but he throws the puck all the way down, gets back out to center, Ruiz has to take over. Minute 35 on the major penalty to Brian Moore. Hat tricks, break it back in, it's Corey Anderson. Anderson waving at that now is Daniel Martin. Rolls off the stick of Brown. Steve Brown will have to move this one near side. Aaron Atwell again. Ruiz. Hat tricks moving this one in. They've got a lot of time on this power play. Not trying to be too over anxious when you've got a major penalty, but it's quickly taking away. 80% of it gone right now. Final minute of it right now. Corey Anderson, a long shot. Stopped by Paulin. A quick whistle there, but he's on top of the rebound. After regaining control, John Batita on top of Gordy Bunnell in front. Carolina starting to gain some traction here on this penalty kill. Now it's Danbury's turn to be frustrated, moving the puck through the neutral zone. Chris Paulin down on one knee, take an extra moment to himself. Blake Peavy on with Cody Oakes, Charlie Pelnick, and Tommy Cardinal. Viktor Grebennikov still out of the lineup for the Thunderbirds after suffering a lower body injury when Carolina visited the Columbus River Dragons. He and Cameron Dimmitt out right now. Then Vinny DeAndre on the bench as an assistant coach tonight for the Thunderbirds. He was released actually before the Thunderbirds game against Danbury last night. Final 55 seconds on the power play here. Right in front, a centering chance from, it was the captain, Johnny Ruiz. Couldn't find a man on the back post. Anderson waiting slowly, weaving his way back out. Up top and sending that one on for Steve Brown. Back down low, Bunnell. Paulin has the goal stick out, trying to chop that pass down. Excellent hand eye by Pelnick. Flipping that puck back out to center. Takes a crazy bounce. And Aaron Atwell goes down. Tommy Cardinal trying to chip that one all the way back down. Anderson gets it back in. Final 20 seconds on what was a major penalty. Backdoor pass. Anderson wanted Ruiz headed towards the goal. Now another chance in front. Turned out there by Paulin. Hits the side of the goal. Bunnell loses it. George Holt motoring back on through center. To the near side, Scotty Donahue. Final 5 seconds. Donahue shorthanded to the goal. Center in front. They score! George Holt ties it up shorthanded. 2-2 from Winston-Salem. George Holt, first goal of the season. Couldn't have come at a better time. The Thunderbirds on the brink of killing off a major penalty, and they come back shorthanded and put an exclamation point on it. Shorthanded goal to tie things at 2. Off the draw. New life in this third period for the Thunderbirds. Peshtuka advances this one on for Scotty Donahue. Low roller coming back in on Jackson. Brought up now by White Duck. Jackson on it here, 10.5 to go, third period. Donahue getting the assist on that one. And around it comes Ramil Talapov. Gus Ford on it now, trying to work things out for Carolina. Back up top, long point draft. Susie, oh, big save by Paul, and he didn't see it till the last second. falling back on his heels and punching it out with the blocker. Through center, Gus Ford. Thunderbirds have that jump in their step right now. Cody Oakes from the bench. On around Scotty Donahue. Donahue following up with Oakes in front. Loose puck. They'll battle for it. Back out in Talipov. Can't settle that one down through center. Talipov wanted Cody Oakes. Deep into the zone. Oakes taken away from him. Hat tricks move this one out. It's Kuznetsov. Both teams finding an extra gear here in the third period. Oakes finds from the bench Blake Peavy. Now Jacob Schnapp. He takes a hit, lost the puck. Hat tricks take it the other way. Pelnick finishes his check on Kuznetsov. Chris Hunt stumbles and the puck comes now to Schnapp. Guided back in by Hunt. Off a skate. Pelnick in at the line. 9.5 to go. Long drive tipped on its way and the bouncer goes wide. Popping back up and Chris Hunt throws it down there. Steve Brown to take it for Dan Barry. Lofts this one back and it bounces right in front of the Carolina bench. Pelnick on the turnover here. Johnny Ruiz has to wait. He'll dump this one in as Finberg touches up and heads to the bench. David Nicoletti. Near side taken by Pelnick. This one moved all the way back down. It goes off one of the hat tricks and so Vinny Susi back to get it. Up the near side, White Duck. Stepped into by George Holt. White Duck avoids him. Throws this into the slot. Daniel Martin gets it out of trouble. Back to center. And now Jackson. Long drive well wide. 8:42 to go. Hat tricks. Out shooting Carolina 31-27 in this game. As Pestuka waits and guides this one all the way back out for Batita. Pass too far for him. They'll rule Batita unable to get a touch on it. It'll go down for an icing. Tied at 2, thanks to a shorthanded goal by George Holt. We'll be back in a moment.
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist.
Two as the Thunderbirds have tied things up with the Danbury hat tricks. 8:29 to go in the third period. A defensive zone faceoff as Chris Paulin strides back to his goal crease. Danbury out shooting Carolina 9-5 in the period, 32-29 on the game. But now it's Tommy Cardinal stealing this one and moving it on for Daniel Martin. Martin over the line. They'll blow that one down off sides. Looked as Cardinal had gotten there first. Martin disagrees with the call for sure. 8:20 to go, so a neutral zone draw. Batita to take it. Against Kodiak, White Duck. Martin has it again off the draw. But now instead the hat trick's taken and flipped this one back in for George Holt. Buzzing after that one. Holt tries to step up. Throw the reversal against White Duck. Can't do it. Batita comes in and helps. Batita through center. Gathering speed down the left side. Wants to cut in and make some room. Got the puck to Tommy Cardinal. He's quickly pushed off of it by White Duck. Daniel Martin blows a tire. Can't move the puck on for John Batita, but he'll have to go after it himself. Batita stepped into. Cardinal throws a hit there. Back out at center, Talipov. Daniluk, the recipient of that Cardinal hit. This one tipped in by John Batita. Paddled down by McEwen. Hat tricks elect to keep this play alive. Back at the red line. All the way back in it comes Steve Brown. On the breakout, Thunderbird crowd back into it here, trying to will their team back out in front. Big scrum on the near sideboards. Scotty Donahue lowers the shoulder. In behind the goal, has his pocket picked here by Corey Anderson. Anderson chopped down by Gus Ford. Ford finds Talipov now, has a bit of a lane. Defenseman comes in and sends that one on goal. McEwen sticks it out. After it catches the glass, Talipov still working back down low. Donahue filling in for his point. And so he'll have to come back and cover it. 3-on-2 come the hat tricks. Ruiz, left wing. Here's a chance with Ruiz in front. The centering pass skipped on its way. Back up top, Susi lets one go. Off a body, it was Talipov. Danilov sends that one back down low. Knocked away by Cody Oakes. Out to the boards. Danilov holds it in. Long try, sent wide. Donahue collects. Skates this one back out to center. 6.5 to go in the third. Puck bounces in. Danilov on it now for Danbury. Away from Hunt. Danilov sends this one back up now for Blake Peavy. Gloved down by Jacob Schnapp. Here comes Chris Hunt. They break into the zone. Hunt tries the toe drag there. Has it taken away from him. Now it's Kodiak White Duck back the other way. Lost the puck a bit. Pestuka steps up on him. Gordy Bunnell will have to tangle deep in Thunderbird territory with Holton Peavy. Bunnell works it free. Jackson in front. Schnapp makes sure that one doesn't find a Danbury stick. Underneath, Jackson again. Right in front. Fanning on the attempt was White Duck. Rebound still loose, and Paulin gets on top. Great chance for White Duck. Peavy shows Brett Jackson the door. Steve Brown got to be careful he doesn't take a penalty here. 5:45 to go in the third, and Brian Moore now out of the box after serving not just his major penalty, but his fighting major as well. Neutral zone faceoff coming up after this one. Extra conversation between Corey Anderson and one of the officials right now. They're coming to the near side. Petita, Martin, and Cardinal. That line back out. And a physical force for the Thunderbirds in this one. Kuznetsov is out with Anderson and Finberg. Top line for Danbury, ready to go to work. Oakes chips this one back in deep. 5.5 to go. Third period of a 2-2 hockey game. Thunderbirds looking to clean things up here against the hat tricks. Here comes Kuznetsov, a high shot. Catches the glass there behind Paulin. Atwell. Near side for Brown. Sent all the way back underneath. Cody Oakes on it here. Puck rolls off of his stick. Now out to the near side. Pelnick has it. Pelnick flips that one up and out. Hits the glass and thought he got away with one. Delay of game call coming up here against Pelnick. That seems to be the only penalty where there's a brief moment of not confusion, but stillness. We've seen a handful of those here at the fairgrounds over the last few weekends. There's pretty much one every game. Player flips it out of the defensive zone, a whistle, and then everyone just kind of goes about their business, go back to the bench, go for a skate, get a drink of water, and the officials don't make an immediate move. But then it's they grab the player and they say, hey, you're not getting away with that one. We saw that. No chance we were going to miss that as a collision out of the corner. Pestuka chips this one back on. Thunderbirds have to kill this off. Now a chance shorthanded. Blake Peavy trying to get after this one. He picks Susie's pocket. Tries to send a turnaround shot on goal there. Fifth power play chance of the night for the hat tricks. As Susie brings this one back in, gets it lost in the shin guards of Peavy and Cardinal. Cardinal takes this one away. He's got a chance shorthanded. Tommy Cardinal down the right side to the goal. Cardinal shot sent over the bar. Big chance by Tommy Cardinal. Had Danilov draped all over him. Great defensive effort by the hat tricks there, but man, what a chance for Cardinal. He was about half a body length short behind the defender. And by the end of that foot race, he'd gotten in and had a good foot of space to himself. Atwell moving things across now. Corey Anderson dropping it off. Brett Taylor takes a hit from Martin. Puck behind the goal to Anderson. 1:08 left on the delay of game penalty to Carolina. Pelnick in the box. Kuznetsov from the left wing hash marks. Sending back down low for Jackson. One of the centering feed. That one hit the stick of Talipov. Long drive there, easy save by Paulin. Aaron Atwell didn't put a lot of speed on that one, but it found its way through traffic. 2-2, Thunderbirds and hat tricks all tied up. We'll be back in a moment.
A lot has changed since 1933, but one thing that hasn't is Modern Automotive's commitment to you. North Carolina car buyers have trusted Modern for 85 years for affordable prices, big selection, and an everlasting commitment to local schools, youth programs, and charitable organizations. It has been our pleasure to earn your business and help make a difference in our community.
Experience the Modern difference. Family owned since 1933.
50 seconds left on this hat tricks power play. Charlie Pelnick in the box, two for delay of game. Ruiz, Bunnell, Anderson, Brown, and Aaron Atwell. The power play unit for the Danbury hat tricks. Three left-handed shots, two right-handers, as one of the right-handers, a shot there sent wide, draw taken by Johnny Ruiz. All the way down, Carolina clears it again. McEwen stops it behind the goal. Atwell collects, 3:44 to go in regulation. 33 seconds on Danbury's power play. Cardinal intercepts, moves things back. Cody Oakes has to wait and send it the length of the ice. Another big clear here for Carolina. Bunnell after this one. Oakes has it in the Thunderbirds' end. Deja vu. Oakes clears the zone. McEwen stops it, letting this one go for Aaron Atwell. One more line change for the Thunderbird penalty killers. Talapov steps into Ruiz. Now Gus Ford comes back the other way. 2 seconds and one. Pelnick out of the box. Thunderbirds have killed off their fifth penalty of the night. 3:03 to go. Here comes Anderson. In over the line, drops things off. Daniluk, long shot, stopped by Paulin. The long wrister does not beat the Thunderbirds goaltender. Danbury's 36th shot of the night. Chris Paulin equal to the task. .257 to go in the third. Looks like we'll have a timeout taken by the hat tricks. Dave McIsaac wants a few moments to go over some stuff with his team. Offensive zone draw coming up here again. McIsaac been all over the hockey world. Back now in Danbury. Hat tricks, Danbury's third FPHL team, coming after the Whalers and the Titans in the early 2010s. And Danbury on a bit of a slide here, losers of four in their last five. Thunderbirds had a difficult November as well, as this is the last game of the month. 0-4-1-0 in the month up until Wednesday and Friday night. Pair of wins there have Carolina trending upward in the FPHL's West Division. The Gunners come out for Danbury. Anderson, Finberg, Kuznetsov lined up directly behind the center. Vinny Susi and Dmitry Daniluk, the point men, but no matter, the Thunderbirds win this defensive zone draw. Brian Moore back out there. Moore trying to cut his way through center. It cost Corey Anderson his stick. But this one thrown back in. Brian Moore chasing after that one against Susi. Moore wins that battle, sends it in front. One at Donahue. Peshtuka waves at that one. Now chopped back. Johnny Ruiz has some speed over the line. Let's it go. Paulin the save. Rebound Ruiz. Paulin sprawling. Ruiz still has the puck. Peshtuka bulldozes a man in front. Long shot by Brown. Never got to the goal. Brian Moore takes control. In behind. As we approach the two-minute mark here, the third. Moore through center. Tries to knife around. One of the hat tricks. Four checkers there. It's moved back out in Cody Oakes. Has to work his way around Charlie Pelnick. Oakes drops it back for Moore. Waved at by Kuznetsov. Near side, Ford picks it up. Off the boards, down the left wing. Dropping it off. Moore waiting. Finberg all over him. Gordy Bunnell. Moore and Bunnell sizing each other up. Up top, Cody Oakes has it. Walks in, lets it go. Blocked by Kuznetsov. Pucks in his pants. Still loose. Final. Chris Hunt pulls it out there. Got a good shot off, and Kuznetsov stumbling on the play. Down the left side, Anderson now breaking into the Thunderbirds' end. Has a couple of players draped all over him. 90 seconds left in regulation. Cody Oaks roaring back with speed for Carolina. Chris Hunt, as Cody Oaks beats everyone to that puck. Trying to move this one on for Hunt. He's got Peavy in front. Oaks back up top. Schnapp taken away there by Ruiz. Pastuca's got to be careful. Bouncing puck just chopped back into Danbury territory. Minute 9 seconds to go. Ruiz, right wing. Blast one, Paul, in the save. Johnny Ruiz got all of that one. Opened the scoring early in the second period. Looked to put Danbury ahead there, but Paulin getting the blocker up against the hip and smothering for a faceoff. Paulin's rebound controls has been outstanding so far tonight. Final 60 seconds, Newco Motors third period. 2-2 between Danbury and Carolina. Headed towards a roller coaster of a finish here. Paulin punches it out. Far side corner, Cardinal there. Throws a hit against Bunnell. Thunderbirds have the puck. Reversal by Cardinal. John Batita throws this one all the way back around. Brown on it here with 35 to go. Back through center, Pastuca finds Batita. On now Martin over the line. Daniel Martin with some time. Finds Batita down the left wing. Towards the net, a shot. Save made there by McEwen. Thunderbirds unable to convert there. Now it's Anderson back the other way with 15 to go. Anderson, a shot. Glove save by Paulin. And Martin has some words after the fact. Thunderbirds got to be careful here. Tommy Cardinal got to be careful not to take a penalty, especially at this point in the game. 14.1 to go. 39-32. Hat tricks out shooting Carolina. ...15-8, Danbury the shots in this third period. Chris Paulin checks his goaltending equipment and prepares to go again. 14.1 to go. Hat tricks looking for a late one here. Paulin and company looking to hold the door shut. Ruiz to take the draw. Thunderbirds win this one. Pelnick wastes no time getting this one back up. Scotty Donahue on through center. Broken play. That one hit Brown up high. And now Ruiz comes back on with speed. Ruiz down the right side. Forced wide. Right in front. Oh, Paulin had left the net. And we've got a whistle and a stoppage. As we will see, the time has expired. Got a little ahead of ourselves there. End of regulation. Big chance for the hat tricks right there at the end. Quick timeout, we'll catch our breath. Kermit's Hot Dog Overtime on the other side of this one.
Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist helps you do more of the things you love. More laughs, more adventures, more hugs. We combine the brightest minds in medicine to bring you world-class care with a commitment to strengthen the health and wellness of our community. Because when it comes to the health of you and your family, no one should settle for anything short of life-changing.
Back inside Winston-Salem Fairgrounds Annex, 2-2 as we approach overtime. Ruiz and Kuznetsov open things off for Danbury in the second. Cody Oaks, his second goal in a Thunderbird uniform. And George Holtz, first of the season, shorthanded, has us tied up. We'll skate at 5 minutes at 3-on-3. Thunderbirds have been through one overtime frame this season. It was not enough. They went to a shootout against Columbus and won it. Danbury 1-1 in overtime. Most recent game, 5-4 overtime loss in Watertown on the 19th. Back the other way they come. Hat tricks to open things up here in overtime. First offensive zone opportunity. Ruiz guiding this one back out to Aaron Atwell. Ruiz, Atwell, and Bunnell against Schnapp, Peavy, and Cody Oakes of the Thunderbirds. Atwell motors on with speed. Cody Oakes looking to step up on him. Atwell cutting in deep against Schnapp. Peavy goes sliding into the goal. Play's going to continue. Oh, they'll blow it dead. Chance back the other way for the Thunderbirds. Could have been a two-on-one. They blow the play dead because the Thunderbirds' goal had gotten knocked off. 4:28 left here in overtime. Typically in an instance like that, when it's a scoring opportunity back the other way, they might let that go. And once Danbury had gotten control of the puck, and if the net was still off at that point, then they would blow it dead. So play stopped, and back at center, Gus Ford will go for it with Corey Anderson. 32 seconds gone in the overtime period. Deja vu at center ice. Three aside. Daniluk with Anderson and Kuznetsov. After Kuznetsov shook off that shot block to the leg. Over the line, Anderson comes. Down the right side, away from Gus Ford. Anderson reverses. Nobody home for Danbury. Donahue has it and advances now for Ford. Ford down the left side. Pestuka joining the rush. Ford cuts across the slot. Doubles back inside the blue line. Gus Ford dipping and diving. He gets taken down. Battles for it with Anderson. And now Donahue has to come back. Gaining control. Hat-tricks in the middle of a line change. Here comes Pestuka down the left side. Right in front. Ford tries to spin a shot on goal. It would not go. Now back the other way come the hat-tricks. Kuznetsov has a chance against Paulin. Kuznetsov deeks and scores. Dmitry Kuznetsov. Hat-tricks take this one in overtime. Minute and a half into the extra frame. Danbury taking this one after Carolina had numbers and speed back the other way. That's the nature of the beast in three-on-three overtime. You get a chance back the other way, you get numbers, you get speed, all of a sudden you gotta go from 100 miles an hour one way to all the way back the other direction. Kuznetsov had the wheels. No one else had any gas left in the tank. Slides it around Paulin. And Danbury takes this one 3-2 on a Saturday night here in Carolina. With the overtime loss, Thunderbirds pick up 4 out of a possible 6 points against the Hat-tricks. Not a total loss. We'll take a break, and when we come back, Budweiser post-game show here on the Thunderbirds Hockey Network.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So, we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
Family owned and operated since 1938, Mustin and Crutchfield Food Market in Kernersville is the place to find your favorite homemade foods. Sample the finest cuts of meat from our on-site butcher, enjoy a glass bottle of soda like the old days, and go home with a tub of our famous homemade pimento cheese. Come see us at 245 North Main Street in downtown Kernersville.
The Carolina Thunderbirds have a set of 2 custom wine labels that can be yours to take home today. The Thunderbirds Red and Carolina White are special edition, first-run custom wine labels for Carolina Thunderbirds fans. Bottles are $40 individually and $75 when bought as a set. Call the Thunderbirds office to get yours today. 336-774-4625. Conveniently
Welcome back to Winston-Salem Budweiser post-game show as the Thunderbirds fall 3-2 to the Danbury Hat-Tricks in overtime. Dmitry Kuznetsov's second goal of the game would prove to be the dagger in OT. Thunderbirds again getting four out of a possible 6 points against Danbury, and after struggling throughout the month of November, not a total loss here. Carolina getting points in all three of their last games. So trying to find the silver lining there for the Thunderbirds going forward. They get the weekend off next weekend. Some time to reset, to regroup, and get ready for Port Huron 2 weeks from Thursday night. Thunderbirds will head back on the road. Carolina only with two home games in the month of December, so it'll be a very travel-laden month coming up here before we turn the calendar ahead to 2022. It's interesting to see that we're almost done with 2021. But the Thunderbirds, again, 3-2 in overtime, falling the Danbury Hat-Tricks. Barnola, three stars of the game. Cody Oakes, tonight's third star. Dmitry Kuznetsov, two goals, including the overtime winner, tonight's second star. And Scotty Donahue, first star honors for the Thunderbirds here in this one. Again, Carolina gets some rest. They'll have 2 weeks to try and regroup, a little shy of 2 weeks to try and regroup and get ready for Port Huron. Danbury gets right back on the bus and heads up to Delaware. They'll play the Thunder tomorrow afternoon, a matinee up there from the Thunderdome. But for the Thunderbirds, again, time to reset, to regroup. Lots of things to like about that game, but time to go back to the drawing board. George Holt, shorthanded goal, really the brightest point of that game for Carolina, looking to set up what could have been a solid comeback there for the Thunderbirds, but not to be. Kuznetsov's speed just too much for the Thunderbirds in this one. But that'll just about wrap things up for us here from Winston-Salem. Final score, Danbury 3, Carolina 2 in overtime. For all of us here at Carolina Thunderbirds TV and the Thunderbirds Radio Network, my name is Dylan Clark. Good night, Carolina. We'll see you next time.